with one tie. The Washington Capitals can tie everything up again, including first place, with a win tonight. Fasten your seatbelts. It's the Washington Capitals and the New York Islanders, live on your superstation for sports, DC 20.
DC 20, your superstation for sports, proudly presents Washington Capitals Hockey. Tonight's game is brought to you in part by Budweiser, the king of beers. By Giant Food. We care about quality and value. We care about you. By Amtrak. Take Amtrak to any one of over 500 destinations nationwide. By Circuit City. By Dashes, with the largest selection of traditional and designer men's clothing. By world-famous Davis Antenna. And by BMW, the ultimate driving machine.
Tonight, live from the Nassau Coliseum on Long Island, it's the Washington Capitals and the New York Islanders here on DC 20. Good evening, everybody. Mike Forens, your play-by-play host, along with Al Koken. The Capitals and the Islanders about to get going here in the last regular season meeting of the campaign, and what an important game this is.
There's so many factors involved, of course, in the race for first place between these two teams, and this game has tremendous playoff implications for the entire Packer division, and it's really the first must-win game the Capitals have faced this year. And we go downstairs to Capitals coach Brian Murray, and Brian, I want to know, how much does recent history with this Islander team factor into tonight's game, talking about both this year and what happened in the playoffs last season?
Well, we certainly know them well. We think that we've made some adjustments for them, as I'm sure they have for us. But there's great respect both ways. I think we have learned, I hope we've learned from past years, from the last game last year, that what a character effort we put forward as well as they did. So all in all, it's something that, who else would you want to play in a game like this but the New York Islanders? I think it's important for us to play well. It's important for us, obviously, to win, to give ourselves a chance for first place. But it's the right team for us to be playing at this time.
Brian, tonight the Islanders will be honoring Denis Potvin, playing his last regular season game in this building in an Islander uniform. I know you have a certain amount of respect for him as a defenseman, and he's been a type of player that can change the fortunes of a game. What do you look for him tonight to really go above and beyond in his swan song here, or do you think he might put a little pressure on himself? He's always handled that pressure pretty well in the past.
Well, he's an experienced hockey player that I'm sure will be enthused by what happens here tonight. The crowd will be good for him. He has played well. In turn, Denis has been in Stanley Cup Finals and won games that were big games, bigger than this game, I guess, for him, although at this time I don't know about that. But certainly we think that there are some things in his game that have slipped a little bit. Hopefully he'll be one of the guys we can take advantage of tonight. But he's an excellent player, and certainly he's had a great career, and I think we all admire what's happened to Denis Potvin.
Brian, we understand you're dressing seven defensemen tonight, bringing Greg Smith back into the lineup. How will you work that out on the ice with the extra defensemen?
Well, what I've done really is open up a right wing spot where I can double shift Mike Gartner, David Christian, or Bengt Gustafsson. I think that's a priority move to start with. It's taking Stephen Leith and Ed Kostelic out of the lineup just because of the youth and inexperience. I think having a Greg Smith and having a Gary Galley both in the lineup at the same time is important for us. I can use Gary and Lambert or right wing the odd time. But they're good people in the dressing room. They're people that are enthusiastic, that can provide a little bit of character, a little bit of experience, and I wanted that for this hockey game.
All right, Brian, best of luck tonight. Thanks for stopping by.
Right, thank you.
Capitals coach Brian Murray is the Caps ready to take on the New York Islanders in this last regular season battle between the two clubs. We'll be back with the opening faceoff of tonight's game right after this.
Does car shopping confuse you? If you've shopped, and I have, you'll find the one place where the confusion ends is your Buick dealer. That's why I just bought a brand new Buick Regal. Regal is actually priced under T-Bird and Cougar. The new Regal just looks like it costs thousands more. So don't get confused. Shop where you like, but start at your Buick dealer. The car is Regal, but the price sure isn't.
Mr. Dave Christian for Provident Savings.
If you think offsides and two-line passes are hard to understand, you should try asking a banker about mortgage rates. Unless, of course, you're asking for a Provident Savings mortgage. They have so many rates and terms, you can almost pick your own and get it fast. At Providence, you get the loan you need, not just something off the shelf. At Providence, we all wear one number, number one.
Providence Savings, member FSLIC.
Do you need to save money?
No matter what your station in life, it's smart to save money on automotive necessities at Tracor.
Do you need to save time?
Young men like myself like to spend their leisure time in places somewhat more romantic than an engine department.
If you need low, low prices, if you need a warranty, if you need it, Tracor's got it.
I just do what I do.
Tracor.
Communications problems. I don't have communications problems. What I do have are business problems. And if communications can help solve them, well, I've got CNP. They do whatever it takes. Whatever it takes.
We put value on the line.
Welcome back to the Nassau Coliseum. It'll be Clint Malarchuk starting in goal for the Washington Capitals in his 53rd appearance of the season. He's 24-19-4 on the year with a 3.06 goals against average. He'll oppose Kelly Hrudey, who's making his 46th appearance of the year for New York. 21-16-5, the mark for Hrudey with a 3.31 average. Hrudey has three shutouts. Malarchuk has four on the year. Referee tonight is Bill McCreary. The linesmen are Bob Hodges and Mark Perry. Here we go with regular season game number 78. The Islanders get the draw and the puck cleared back inside the Washington zone. Here's Larry Murphy back to play it. Murphy throws it over on the right wing side for Mike Gartner. Gartner flips it out to center ice and Miller goes across the line after it. And as it's finally touched there, offside is called against the Washington Capitals. The Caps with 84 points, second in the Patrick Division. Terry Simpson's Islanders, 86 points, first place in the Patrick Division. There's 2 points separating these teams, and tonight the final regular season game for Denis Potvin here in the Nassau Coliseum. Now, the Islanders have two more games coming up on the road, and I'm sure they'll be seeing him here in the playoffs, but a big night here on Long Island for Denis Potvin.
Honored before the game by John Ziegler, will be honored after the game by the New York Islander organization, and there are rumors that the Islander organization will retire uniform number 5 tonight.
Here's Langway out to Bobby Gould. Gould back to Rod Langway, now leads to center ice. It's into the skates of Greg Adams. Adams off the stick of Gould, taken back by the Islanders. Here's Potvin into the Washington zone. He throws it behind the Capitals net. Langway's back to play it. Sends it up the boards now for Sundstrom to the point. Kept in by Potvin. His shot goes wide as Langway was able to move Kerr out from in front. Here's Gould inside the Islander zone. Potvin fails in a hip check. Gould centers. It just misses Sundstrom and the Isles come back on the attack. No score. We're just underway with the first minute of the game. The puck shot back inside the Washington zone. Here's Hatcher to send it ahead for Bobby Gould on right wing. Out to center ice and Peter Sundstrom for the Capitals charges to the Islander line. Gets into the New York zone. He's pushed away now by King. The puck played right out in front by Hrudey from the Islander net. And here's Tomas Jonsson to start out. Now Gustafsson tries to keep it in the Islander zone, but King brings it back out. He flips to center ice and Scott Stevens takes over back at his own line. Lead pass Gustafsson looking for Christian on the right wing boards, but it's played out to center. Here's Ledyard dumping it back inside the New York zone. Tomas Jonsson back to get it. The game is a minute and a half old. Up to King on the left wing boards, out to center ice. Ledyard steals the puck at the red line. He starts back for Washington. Slap shot kicked aside by Hrudey and played off the boards. Now for Pat LaFontaine to center, but Gustafsson takes over for the Capitals. No score here in the early going. Michael Pavanka on the right wing for Dave Christian. Gets inside the line. Ken Morrow plays it back now behind his own net. He leads it over on the left, on the right wing side, and it comes out to center for King. King across the blue line hits Mikko Makela. A shot and a goal. Makela backhanding a low drive that beats Clint Malarchuk on the stick side. New York has taken a 1-0 lead.
The Capitals have seen enough of Mikko Makela by now to know he has terrific outside speed, and they still let him get wide and come inside. And he beats Malarchuk with a nice backhander. Well, we'll see on the replay. I thought maybe Clint could have had it, but right there, you know the speed that Makela's got. Gustafsson, he gets that little step on him before Scott Stevens closes on him. Mikko Makela sends a perfect shot along the ice. It looked like Clint Malarchuk had time to play it, even though it ducked in on that far post. An absolutely pinpoint shot, but could have been stopped. The Islanders take the big 1-0 lead in this critical game.
That's number 36 of the season for Mikko Makela. Time of the goal, 2:05. Derek King and Jeff Norton get the assists. Out at center, here's Potvin to play it. Throws it rink wide. Makela backs it up now, and Greg Gilbert tosses to the Washington blue line. Here comes Makela at another bad angle. Stops in the corner. Langway tries to take him out. The puck's loose. They score! Gilbert stuffs it home past Malarchuk, and New York has jumped out to a quick 2-0 lead.
Case not only of the speed but of the Capitals being outworked in front. Now Rod Langway gets faked out there, and before he can take Makela out completely, you've got nobody to help out with Gilbert in front. Once Makela's finally taken out, there's not a defenseman there. Now watch, the Makela puts a nice little move on Langway. Hatcher takes out Bassen, so help has to come from the forwards. Dale Hunter really runs into his own man, and nobody covers up on Greg Gilbert, wide open in front. Flat play again by the Capitals early in these games. They've had terrible trouble in that regard, Mike, in their own zone. A team so physical, a team so strong, a team whose forwards are trained to be disciplined and come back and help in that situation. And too many times lately, they have left people wide open in front of their own cage.
It's Gilbert's 17th goal of the season. Makela and Diduck get the assists at 2:35. Right now, Brian Murray just trying to settle his team down and get them into the game. They trail 2-0. The puck sent on net. Here's Kelly Hrudey playing it up the right wing boards for Kerr. He's challenged by Gartner. Kerr sends it over now to Rich Kromm. Kromm starts on the attack. Up to center ice. Here's LaFontaine across the line to Konroyd. He shoots! And a glove save made by Malarchuk, who just caught a piece of it. Out comes Murphy to center. Murphy pulled down and neutralized. The puck sent back inside the Islander zone. Here's Konroyd. Up the boards, the puck goes to the corner, and play has been stopped with 16:48 remaining here in the first period, and we've got the game's first penalty call coming for slashing. There's a break in the action with a score, Islanders 2-0.
You can save a bundle shopping around, but you can save time and money during Tyson Sports Money Saving Days. Save on Festivas, only $49.95. Escorts from $55.95. Top Ranger trucks from $59.90. Cash back rebates up to $1,000, and no payments till July makes this Money Saving Days a real bargain at Tyson's Ford. You get the wheel when you take the wheel,
Tyson's Ford dealing. With Alan Kerr in the box for slashing, it's time for the first Circuit City Power Play contest of the night. Contestant number one, Kelly Brown of Gaithersburg, Maryland. Kelly has chosen Scott Stevens as the Capitals player to score on this power play. If Scott Stevens scores, Kelly receives a video or stereo unit courtesy of Circuit City.
Alan Kerr in the box for slashing at 3:12 of the first period. Washington needs some scoring here. They're down 2-0 and right now have the power play. At the point, Scott Stevens, a blast, a rebound shot, and two big saves by Kelly Hrudey. The puck played into the corner. Here's Gustafsson back to the point for Murphy. Rink wide, over to Scott Stevens. He keeps it in. In behind the goal, here's Gustafsson going back to take it. He's challenged in the corner. The puck ridden over now for Murphy and put back for Gustafsson to Hunter. Hunter back to Murphy at the point. A slap shot and a kick save. Hrudey deflects that into the crowd off a blistering drive from the point by Larry Murphy.
Yeah. Larry Murphy is the man who gets that drive, the big kick save. But before that, David Christian was robbed by Kelly Hrudey. After Scott Stevens lines up a shot from the point, Hrudey will make that save. Christian right there tried to get it by Hrudey, but Hrudey diving over to block it with a body before David Christian can lift it up. Three terrific saves by Kelly Hrudey. On the scoreboard, Quebec and Philadelphia right now tied up at one, and the New Jersey Devils, can they continue their mastery over Pittsburgh? They lead 1-0 on a goal from Bruce Driver.
Now the Capitals got two very quick goals on Kelly Hrudey the last time they played in this building on February the 27th and went on to shut out the Islanders 3-0. And they had the first three goals of the game in their last meeting at the Capitol Center before the Islanders roared back to score three more in the second period and eventually ended up in an overtime tie. I'm sure a big part of the Islander game plan tonight, get to the Capitals early. Exactly. And they've done it.
Don't let them get things started. It's the Capitals' fashion normally is that way, even the latest incidents of blowing some early leads. Still, that is the way they win most of their games.
Here's Christian in the corner now for Washington with 55 seconds left to go on the Capitals power play. Bengt Gustafsson goes into the corner after it. Here's Gustafsson back to the point for Scott Stevens. Has it poke checked by Kromm out to center. 40 seconds left in Kerr's penalty. Here's Christian across the line. Batted down by a high stick from an Islander player, and as it's recovered by Diduck, there'll be a faceoff in the New York zone. 38 seconds left in the Kerr penalty, 15:26 remaining in the first period.
We talk about the emotion that Denis Potvin will feel. Well, it's obvious that his teammates are feeling it as well. Capitals have seen the return of Tim Kerr for the Philadelphia Flyers, get them jacked up and play a big game. So it's that type of emotional evening that can really work for a team if they harness it the right way and don't allow themselves to get too high. And it seems like Kelly Hrudey has got himself harnessed perfectly at the beginning of this game.
Here's Ridley along the sideboards now trying to set up for the Capitals on the power play attack. Gives it to Gary Galley. He tosses it into the corner. Greg Adams goes in to dig it out. Back over to Ridley. Here's Ridley cutting in. Centers. It's wide right through the goal mouth. Now back to the point for Hatcher. Into the corner. It bounces away from Ridley, and Galley goes to the other side to keep it in. Now Ken Morrow tries to move it out from the corner, but Gartner is there. Galley piles into the corner. Finally, the puck is frozen underneath the fallen Brent Sutter, and play is stopped. Down to only 3 seconds left now in the Kerr penalty.
Mike, one thing that has been missing so far in this Capitals power play, even though they've had some good chances, has been an appearance in the crease from a guy like Greg Adams or a guy like Dale Hunter. Remember the last time the Capitals played the Islanders, Greg Adams was a major focus of frustration by Kelly Hrudey in particular, claiming he was in that crease interfering, and Hrudey went after everybody in a Capitals uniform, but nobody has been able to establish himself in front of Hrudey right now, and I think that is something the Capitals must do to see if Hrudey is still on that emotional streak and will get himself out of the game. He's off to a great start, so you better get in that crease area and start challenging him.
From the draw, here's Potvin playing it up the left wing boards out to center ice. The penalty's over to Kerr, and New York is at full strength. Gould tosses it back inside the Islander zone. Here's Diddick behind the net. Leads a long pass out to center. It's too high over the stick of Kerr, and Langway comes up with it back in his own zone. He sends it all the way down. This will be icing as Diddick goes back to get it. And the faceoff reverts to the Washington zone with 14:27 to play here in the first period. There's a break in the action with a score. The Islanders 2 and the Capitals nothing.
Hey, Fred, give me a pizza with extra cheese.
Extra cheese.
And hold the tomato sauce.
Hold the tomato sauce.
And hold the crust.
Hold the crust.
Hey, Jimmy, give me a cheese with nothing.
Nothing?
Now you can have the best part of the pizza without the pizza. Polio string cheese, all natural, individually wrapped cheese snacks.
Is this what you want?
Bellissimo. Magnifique.
C'est bon.
Try Polio string cheese. It's the best part of the pizza.
There's 14:27 left to play in this first period. Al Koken and Mike Bourne's with you from the Nassau County Coliseum on DC 20. The Islanders have roared off to the start of a 2-0 lead over the Caps.
Play underway back in the Washington zone. Both clubs at full strength. Here's Grant Ledyard to start out. Leads it to Peter Sundstrom. Gets by him and goes back inside the Islander zone. Here's Diddick to play it up the sideboards, and Kerr takes over now for New York. Out at center ice, here's Kromm. Gets across the line, dumps it into the Washington zone. Langway trips up Kromm. The Islander fans wanted a penalty, but none is called. Now here's Miller on the left wing. Gets it outside the line, and Kromm dumps it right back in, but Ledyard brings it out to center. Grant Ledyard shoots it back inside the New York Islander zone. Into the corner is Miller with Gould. Puts it behind the net. And Potvin clears it away from Sundstrom. Out comes Kerr to center. Taken over by Grant Ledyard. Ledyard puts it back into the Islander end, and here comes Greg Gilbert, who scored the second Islander goal tonight. The first one came from Mikko Makela, giving New York the 2-0 lead. Christian starts out to Gustafsson, gets it to center ice. And now Konroyd has it taken away by Gustafsson. He's in with Christian across the line. Hadik walks in front, has it played away by Jonsson. The puck's still loose, and finally Gilbert recovers in the corner. He throws it against the sideboards. Pavanka tried to center, but it's blocked by Jonsson. Now Gustafsson has it taken away. Here's Konroyd bringing it ahead for New York to Gilbert. He flips to center ice, and Murphy knocks it down. Over to Scott Stevens into the Washington zone. Stevens ahead for Michael Pavanka down the left wing. Pavanka cutting in, fires a shot, saved to Hrudey. The rebound bounced to the corner as Christian and Konroyd tangled for it. Now Gilbert flips it out to center ice, and Stevens takes over. Gilbert has been out there a long time on this shift and has had his helmet knocked off. The puck cleared all the way in, and Morrow is back for it. Icing is called against Washington.
Tickets for playoff games A and B are on sale now. The dates of the games are dependent on the outcome of the Panther Division race. If the Caps finish in first or second, games A and B will be Wednesday and Thursday night, the 6th and 7th of April at 7:30 p.m. at the Capitol Center. If Washington finishes third or fourth, games A and B will be Saturday and Sunday night, the 9th and 10th of April, also 7:30 game times. Tickets are available at all Hex ticket centers, or you can call Phone Charge right now at area code 202-432-0200 or the 1-800 number 448-9009, and operators will be on duty until 11 p.m.
Here's Hatcher to start out. LaFontaine bounces it into the corner for King. He centers, just missing Kerr. Miller hustles over after it. Played behind the net. Here's Greg Smith for the Capitals. Sends it up the right wing boards. Gartner to the point. It's kept in by Norton. His shot goes wide. Here's Kelly Miller. Out to center ice. Gartner hits Miller with a pass at the blue line. Over to Ridley on right wing. Mike Ridley taken over but gets it away to the point. Here's Smith, a slap shot kicked wide. We have a delayed penalty call coming up. There's going to be a minor for interference against the Islanders. And that'll give Washington their second power play opportunity of this game. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders 2 and the Capitals nothing.
Hi, sports fans. I like sports, but I like movies too. And the satellite dish that I got from Davis Antenna gets me over 400 movies each week. So why even fool around with cable? Satellite movie channels really give you a whole lot more to choose from. So if you like movies, then satellite TV is for you. Why not make Davis Antenna your movie connection like I did? And you'll get movies that are out of this world.
Be like Art Monk. Call now. Don't be left out. Call today.
Ken Morrow, the New York Islanders interference, the call at 8:04. He grabbed up with Kelly Miller, the top of that right faceoff circle, preventing Miller from getting into that play. Cap's second power play opportunity. It's happening to the right of your screen.
From the faceoff, the puck cleared all the way back inside the Washington zone. We're back to live action now. A 2-0 Islander lead, 11 minutes and 45 seconds to play here in the first period of the game. The Capitals on their second power play chance. An earlier one, not productive, while Kerr was off the ice for slashing. This time it's Morrow for interference at 8:04. Here's Potvin into the corner, taken away by Hunter. Dale Hunter for the Capitals walks across the faceoff circle, drops it back now for Mike Ridley. To the point for Hatcher, back to Ridley, to Hatcher. He one-times it wide, and it bounces off the glass and caroms into the seats. Now bounces off the side of that pane of glass now in the corner. Looked like that was going to be out of play. It wound up in play. Here's Sutter trying to clear it out, kept in by Hunter. Galley walking in, takes it to the side of the goal for Gartner. 1 minute to go in the power play. Gartner cuts in front with a pass. It's blocked by Potvin and cleared by Diddick. Seconds to go now in that penalty call. Here's Christian across the line. Ties up with Konroyd. The puck comes to Pavanka out front. Murphy, a shot. It's blocked by Trottier right in front and cleared all the way down. Malarchuk over to the corner after it. Only 20 seconds left now in the Washington power play. Here's Christian up to center ice. Gets across the blue line. Christian tries to throw it in front for Murphy, and that's picked off easily by Kerr. Alan Kerr across the line with Norton, taken over by Michael Pavanka. Here's Gustafsson starting out. Morrow's out of the box. The Islanders at full strength. Murphy inside the New York zone. Tosses to the corner, and Morrow goes back to play it. Capitals change up on the fly. Lead pass to center ice, broken up by Kelly Miller. Trottier hits him, and it's thrown in by Norton. Here's Scott Stevens behind the net. Loses the puck to Kerr. Tried to stuff it in. Wide, right through the goal mouth. Malarchuk got just enough of it. Here's Stevens out of his own end. Out to center ice for Sundstrom. He's challenged by Potvin, hit right at center. And play has been called with 9:21 to go here in the first period. And the Islanders holding a 2-0 lead over the Capitals.
And it almost was 3-0. Watch how close this thing comes. Alan Kerr does the good job of getting in there. Malarchuk gets over the last second, but Kerr's little sweep attempt walks right there just a few inches above that goal line. Talk about Denis Potvin retiring at the end of the year. When you see him play like this, you wonder why. He gets down there and blocks the shot there. Before that, he had taken Mike Ridley completely out of the slot. He can still do that type of work. You see him play the way he has played this season, and you would think he would be good for at least one more year, but he claims he's not going to be dissuaded. His decision to retire at the end of this year will stick.
Well, everybody's already given him all those gifts.
That's
right.
Have
to return them. Here's a shot by Bobby Gould. I think it would have gone wide, but Hrudey takes no chances, just reaching out and making the glove save. There's a break in the action with a score. The Islanders 2, the Capitals nothing.
Another 30 seconds of common sense.
The lowest priced four-door sedan in America versus the closest competitor. Here, the very sensible Hyundai Excel at just $59.95. Reclining bucket seats, wall-to-wall carpeting, loaded with standard features. But to be honest, the second lowest priced four-door has all this and more. Lucky for us, it's also at your Hyundai dealer. The XL GL.
Starting Monday, the all-new dating game and the love connection are changing positions. That's the all-new dating game weeknights at 11 p.m., followed by the love connection at 11:30 p.m. It's all right here on DC20.
You didn't write that, did you?
You can still call me Bachelor Number One.
Here's Galley from the faceoff to Corvo, a high shot, and Hrudey blocks that into the corner, and it goes over the glass out of play. The Islanders missing several players due to injury tonight. Mike Bossy still out with that back problem. Pat Flatley out for the season with a knee injury, and Neil Coulter out with a thumb injury. They've also scratched Ken Leiter from the game tonight, as well as Mick Vokoda. Back to the point. Here's a shot by Langway right on. Hrudey hangs on and stops play. Among the Capitals' scratches, well, we're going to have a penalty call here coming. This is 2 minutes for roughing, and it looks like it's going to be against Washington. There's a break in the action with a score. Islanders 2, Capitals nothing.
Get tight.
We gon' party.
With the right side of the law.
Do you know why I love you?
Stop the car!
You don't live the way other people live.
One man.
You just made number 4 on the most wanted list.
One rule.
I want to be number 1.
Meet Nico. He's a cop with an attitude. Above the law. Rated R. Special sneak preview Saturday, April 2nd.
Dale Hunter in the box for the Capitals. Roughing is the call at 11:07. Watch the right part of the screen. Hunter and LaFontaine tangled up. Hunter smacking LaFontaine in the head as Rod Langway takes the shot.
But Corvo got knocked down there by Potvin pretty good, too.
Look at the job the Islanders doing now, clearing out that crease. It was the problem at the Capitol Center early for the Islanders. They certainly have started out this game tough in front in that slot area in front of Kelly Hrudey, with Denis Potvin leading the way.
From the draw, the puck comes back to Potvin behind the net. Time of the penalty call to Hunter at 11:07. Hunter for roughing, giving the Islanders their first power play opportunity. New York rated 8th in the league at 22%. The Capitals 5th in the league at killing off penalties at 82%. Here's Jonsson back in his own zone. Lead pass out to center ice. Makela across the line. Feeds it into the corner for Trottier. Back to LaFontaine behind the net. Pat LaFontaine out to Jonsson to the point for Potvin. Back over to Jonsson. Rink wide. Makela, a wrist shot. Up high and wide of the net. Cleared to Jonsson at the point. He keeps it in. Now Hatcher picks it up and sends it all the way down to ease the pressure. 8 minutes to go. First period. Islanders on top 2-0. A minute remaining in the penalty. Here's a shot just wide. LaFontaine digs it out from behind the net. Over to Potvin. Kicked away by Sundstrom out to neutral ice, and the Islanders forced to retreat after it. Trottier inside the Washington zone, but here's Hatcher to steal. He backhands it all the way back into the Islanders zone. 40 seconds to go in the Hunter penalty. Lead pass out to Pat LaFontaine. Flips it across the line back inside the Washington zone, and here's Stevens behind the net. Scott Stevens for the Capitals. Plays it out to Gustafsson. He dumps it back inside the New York zone. 20 seconds remaining in the Islander power play. They lead the Capitals 2-0. Let out to center ice. Lauer checked as he crosses the line. A shot hits the side of the net. A wrist shot by King hits the side of the goal as Malarchuk was holding on to that post. Time runs out on the Hunter penalty, and the Capitals are at full strength. Here's Miller to keep it inside the Islander zone. Flips it right in front. Gartner a shot, and a save made by Hrudey. Gartner had very little time and just let it fly, but Hrudey stopped him. Now Ledyard back at center ice. Waits on Miller to get out of the Islander zone. Brings it over to Murphy. Back to Grant Ledyard. Charges up the middle, and Jeff Norton takes it over. Long right wing pass. Kerr with a slap shot wide. Gartner starts out for the Capitals. Up to center ice. Dumps it into the corner. Here's Miller going to chase it. Jonsson's right on him. They jam up in the corner. Now Gartner works it free. Tried to give it to Larry Murphy, but that's stolen. Back come the Islanders on the attack. Dale Henry inside the Washington zone. Poke check by Gartner back to the point. Konroyd keeps it in. Here's Ledyard to the corner. Sends it up the boards. Bob Bassen takes the puck for New York, but gives it away, and Gartner picks it up. He starts to center. Capitals starting a line change. Here comes Ridley into the Islander zone. Tries to look for Pavanka. It's stolen. The Capitals' passing game is not up to par. Here's Jonsson walking in. Centers it. It's blocked right in front. And Gartner steals and starts back with Pavanka. Michael Pavanka out to Murphy. Capitals complete the line change. The Islanders get a whole new unit out there. Langway back in his own zone. Ahead for Gustafsson. He's being forechecked by Makela. Finally, Christian comes to help, but it's too late. Trottier takes it away. Now Christian pulls alongside and flips it ahead to center ice. Greg Adams hustling back inside the New York zone, but he's pressed against the sideboards. Norton throws it rink-wide, and Gustafsson keeps the play going for the Capitals. Bengt Gustafsson, a slap shot. That's wide of the Islander net. Back to the point. Hatcher bounces it behind the goal. Adams chases after it, gives it back to Hatcher in front. Adams tries to tip it, and it's played away by Norton to the corner. Makela, long lead pass, too far for Gilbert. This goes all the way down the ice, and Hatcher back to get it first. Icing is the call. 4 minutes and 40 seconds remaining here in this first period, and the Islanders clinging to that 2-0 lead over the Capitals.
You can guarantee yourself the best seat available for all the Cap home playoff games. All you need to do is put down a deposit on a season ticket or partial plan for next year. That will entitle you to purchase the best available ticket to all the Cap home playoff games. For more information on this, give the Cap sales reps a call right now at 386-7000. They're standing by throughout tonight's game to answer all of your questions. At number again, 386-7000. Kelly Hrudey has been absolutely brilliant. Kelly Miller makes a great play, the turnover. You see how quickly Mike Gartner's got to get the shot away. Kelly Hrudey comes out, cuts down the angle.
Here's Gartner, a blast from the point, but this is caught. Hrudey saw it through a crowd and holds on. Kelly Hrudey beat Edmonton 5-4 last Saturday night and is unbeaten now in his last three starts with two victories, no losses, and a tie during that span. Terry Simpson going with Billy Smith just two evenings ago when the Flyers came to town, but turned back to Kelly Hrudey for this game here against the Capitals. Kevin Hatcher back on the point, has Stevens paired with him on the left. Hunter is up front with Gartner and Ivan Korovo. They go against Sutter, who's on with Lauer and Henry. Diddick and Potvin are the New York defense pairing. Here's Potvin with the draw back of the goal and starts out now with 4:28 to play here in the first period. Leads it ahead for Henry. Dale Henry drops it on the left wing side, and Stevens throws a hard hit that knocks Henry down. He still hasn't gotten up. And in the Capitals control the puck, but they have now blown the whistle. And trainer Craig Smith comes out to take a look at Dale Henry, who was the recipient of a very, very hard hit from Scott Stevens.
Last time the Capitals played the Islanders in Washington, Scott Stevens almost in exactly the same position on the ice laid out Bob Bassen. Bassen came up with a concussion, missed three games, and in fact is just returning to the lineup this evening after being nailed by Scott Stevens. Now, generally, Scott Stevens' open ice hits are very, very clean. No stick or elbow involved. Usually gets that shoulder down. We'll catch it here. There is number 20, and it once again tucks the elbow in. That shoulder's there. You just couldn't ask for a cleaner check in that regard.
Right in the solar plexus. Very similar to others that we've seen Scott throw. And you can understand in seeing that hit why he's not getting up. He's just got the wind knocked so far out of him, he can't even draw a breath. There's a break in the action with a score. The Islanders 2 and the Capitals nothing.
Toyota Corolla. First time I saw the new one, I said, that's a Corolla.
And why'd you say that?
It doesn't look like a Corolla. It's beautiful. And from where the driver sits, it's even more beautiful.
How so?
Great handling. Multi-valve performance. Sporty interiors. Beautiful. But I still keep thinking, this is a Corolla?
The new Dimension Corolla. Legendary value. Toyota quality.
Who could ask for anything more?
Dale Henry's still being worked on by the Islander medical staff. While we've got a moment, Mike, would love to wish, or pass on, we should say, our congratulations to one of our top producers, supervising producers back in the studio, man who helps run things sports-wise at WDCA-TV-20, Marty Corwin and his wife, Cheryl. Claudia, excuse me, daughter Cheryl, 7-pound daughter that Claudia gave birth to, and we pass on our congratulations. Understand, you know, Marty also doing some directing as well, and that Lamaze at the end, instead of just the breathe, 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 it was baby in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
All right. Congratulations to the Corwins. Not much breathing being done here by Henry following this hit from Scott Stevens.
Now, once again, if he comes with the stick, if he ups with the elbow, then you can see why the Islander fans deserve a penalty that they're calling for. But there's no question, once again, it's just a clean open ice hit that Scott Stevens has thrown many, many times in his career, a number of times this year, and as far as I'm concerned, he's the best at it right now in the business.
The lost art, but Scott certainly got it back on track. Here's Hatcher, dumps it all the way down the ice into the Islander zone, and Makela goes to play it, throws it rink wide now for Jonsson. See if the hit picks up the Capitals a bit. They trail 2-0. Hatcher slaps it back inside the New York zone. Here's Jonsson. Over to Gilbert. Now out to Makela. to Trottier. Wrist shot off the leg of Kevin Hatcher. He sends it out to the blue line. Here's Gartner. Flips it back to center, and Jonsson to play it at the New York line. Over to Gilbert. Stolen puck. Hatcher gets it. Feeds it left wing side for Korvo, and he dumps it inside the Islander end. Jonsson back to play the puck. 3:20 to go. First period. New York with a 2-0 lead. Here's Jonsson ahead to Konroyd. Sends it into the Washington zone. Into the corner goes Stevens after it. Tries to get it away from King to the point. Kept in by LaFontaine. Just wide of the net for King. He tries to stuff it in front, but it's played out by Stevens, who sends it all the way down, taking no chances. It'll be picked up here by Norton, and the call is icing against the Capitals with 2:56 to play in the first period. A look out of town tonight, Al, in the game between the Flyers and the Nordiques. There is Henry still trying to get his wind.
Still thinks he's out of town.
Yes. Gosselin is in goal for Quebec, Hextall for Philadelphia. Anton Stastny is 27th of the year, and Poulin scoring for Philadelphia. It's 1-1 in the first period. New Jersey at Pittsburgh, Sean Burke against Steve Gannett. Bruce Driver's goal has given the Devils the 1-0 lead. Montreal at Boston tonight, Patrick Waugh against Reggie Lemelin. No score in the first period. And Hartford at Buffalo, Mike Liut playing for the Whalers against Tom Barrasso for the Sabres. Dave Tippett for Hartford, and it's Arneal and Napier for the Sabres, giving them a 2-1 lead, Buffalo over Hartford.
This delay, Brian Murray wanted to get Dale Hunter out there to take this faceoff in the defensive zone. Referee Bill McCreary wouldn't allow it, so Bengt Gustafsson must come back to square off against Pat LaFontaine.
The draw goes in behind the Washington net, and chasing it is Ledyard. He sends it off the boards out to center ice, and now it's ruled a stoppage in play. The faceoff will be in the neutral zone. The puck knocked down by a high stick.
Mike, as we talked about before the game, this contest has so many implications, and if you're not familiar with the tie-breaking procedures, go through it for you. First, the tiebreaker is number of victories, and right now the two teams tied at 38. Then points in the season series, and remember the Patrick division, it's got to be cut down to 6 games. That's why this game is so important. This is only the third game the Islanders have played here against the Caps, so this one counts.
The game that's thrown out, the first meeting. Here's a slap shot. Norton's drive is deflected into the crowd.
So right now, if you throw out the first meeting between the two teams, they come into tonight's game tied 2-2-1. The winner of this game then would have the leg up on that second tiebreaker, and the third tiebreaker, regular season goal differential. And right now, the New York Islanders lead in that department. They've got a plus 41 compared to the Capitals plus 37. So the Islanders with a lot of things going their way in that regard. Why the Capitals need to come up with a victory here.
Well, evidently the Nordiques aren't laying down. They lead the Flyers by a score of 2-1. Quebec has already finished for the year. They're not going to make the playoffs. And look what a performance Ron Lapointe's team is coming up with against the Flyers. Back-to-back games for those two clubs.
And look what happened with the Detroit Red Wings. They have certainly clinched a lot of things, and they played the Capitals very, very tough. Looked like they were battling for a playoff spot instead of having one already wrapped up.
Potvin is back to get it for another icing call. The faceoff returns to the Washington zone with 2:18 left here in the first period.
Absolutely amazing when you look at the statistics and the categories that Denis Potvin leads all NHL defensemen for the career. He's the top career defenseman in terms of goals scored, assists, points, playoff games, playoff goals, playoff assists, playoff points, all-star goals, and all-star points. Among every defenseman who's ever played the game, Denis Potvin leads them all in those categories.
From the draw, it's chased behind the Washington net by Greg Smith. He's taken out of the play, and Hatcher picks it up and bounces the puck all the way back into the Islander zone. Gerald Diduck back to retrieve in New York ice. Pass deflected, goes all the way down, and Malarchuk steers it aside for Greg Smith. 2 minutes to go in the first period. Smith to the corner. Chased by Rich Kromm. Throws it behind the net. Bassen puts it back of the goal, and here's Bob Gould jamming up with Kerr. Now Hatcher backhands it off the glass. Kromm into the corner. Bobby Gould taps it behind the goal, and here's Greg Smith. Hit hard on the play by Bassen. Smith and Bassen tangled as they start back up ice. Kerr starts across the Washington line and is twisted around by Hatcher. And here's Greg Smith to start out again for the Capitals. Smith throws it in from center. It strikes Gilbert in the back, and Gilbert now makes the play for New York. 1:10 to go. First period of play. Larry Murphy back at his own line. Gets it away from Potvin out to Miller. He pokes it back inside the New York zone. For the Islanders, Konroyd back after it. We're in the final minute of play in the period. Ahead to Gilbert. Taps it off the boards to Trottier. Bryan Trottier into the Washington zone. Tries to get past Murphy. Murphy stays with him. The puck cleared over to the sideboards. Now Trottier behind the net. Murphy right in there to steal the puck for Washington. Here's Larry Murphy for the Capitals. Out to Sundstrom. Plays it ahead to Ridley. Ridley drives it in from center ice. Hrudey stops it behind the goal and leaves it there now for Jonsson. 30 seconds to play in the period. Miller back out at center. Dumps it into the Islander end, and Konroyd back to chase it. Former Calgary Flames Steve Konroyd shoots to center ice. Stevens knocks it down over to Murphy. 15 seconds to go in period one. Here's Murphy. At the point, a slap shot, kick save, rebound. Gartner throws it in front, and that's knocked down. Time running out, the puck sent to the side of the goal, and Hrudey is able to cover it up with just 1 second remaining here in the first period.
The Capitals have had a few chances on some scrambles, but no real clear good second chances way in front. Now, you see what happens, though. When you shoot down low on Kelly Hrudey, he has a tendency to give you that rebound back out in traffic. Mike Ridley couldn't take advantage there, but if you get it up to the glove side, high up on the glove side in particular, he'll just eat it up. And now the Capitals, with only 1 second left, will pull Clint Malarchuk, get an extra attacker on to try and get something real quick off this faceoff. But if you get it down at the feet of Kelly Hrudey, he showed in the playoffs last year, those rebounds will come back out in traffic, but the Capitals aren't really following up on some of those second chances.
Six attackers for the Capitals here, and only 1 second to pull something off, but it'll be up to the Islanders to do a defensive job here. LaFontaine against Dave Christian. They're going to try to get the puck to Hatcher for the shot. Christian goes to Hatcher, and he blasts it right up into the collarbone of Hrudey. Hatcher got it away all right, but Hrudey made the save, and he's feeling the effects of it. He stopped the puck, and that was his job, but he's shaken up a bit and getting up, and we've finished tonight's first period. The Capitals wind up with 14 shots on goal to only 5 for the New York Islanders, but are outscored by New York 2-0. Here you see from the draw that very quick faceoff. Christian wins it, and Hatcher comes in and just slams it, and it strikes Hrudey right in the collarbone area, and he went down feeling that one after making the save. Makela and Gilbert giving New York the lead. We'll have more hockey coverage from the Nassau Coliseum after we pause for these messages here on your superstation for sports, DC 20.
Come to Chevy City and check this tech before you buy. Come.
$1,000 cash back.
In business, changes are just a fact of life. For example, you can type something perfectly, and then new information comes in.
Okay, that's perfect, but would you change the opening?
Maybe that's why secretaries prefer Xerox typewriters.
Oh, and add that comma.
They make revisions easy. In tests, 8 out of 10 people preferred a Xerox typewriter to other leading models, even an IBM.
And that's it, okay?
No problem.
Xerox, the perfect typewriter for the way business really is.
The signs are beginning.
It's incredible.
Why is this happening?
There's a whole chain of signs, like a countdown. The Bible's filled with them.
She was chosen.
Your baby's due in February, the 29th.
How'd you know that?
She alone can prevent the seventh sign.
It's time for you to know it, Abby.
Abby!
You can't stop it.
Demi Moore in The Seventh Sign, rated R.
For 4, 4 for 5, it took him 9 seconds. And once in a while, referees know me as number 8. But in banking, numbers just get in the way of good service. At Providence Savings, we all wear the same number, number 1. Free checking with interest, offices and drive-ins open till 7 every weeknight, you bet. And more services that meet your needs. At Providence Savings, we all wear the same number, number 1.
Provident Savings, member FSLIC.
Are you in the market for a new home? Let Preference Homes make your decision with superior craftsmanship, beautiful interior designs, and flexible financing. Veterans move in with just $1,999 cash.
Call Preference Homes at 341-7400.
Preference is the difference.
Thanks to goals by Mikko Makela and Greg Gilbert, just 30 seconds apart early in the first period, the New York Islanders have taken a 2-0 lead over the Washington Capitals after 20 minutes of action from the Nassau Coliseum here in Uniondale, Long Island. Welcome back to Capitals Hockey on DC 20. I'm Al Koken, and joined in this first intermission by Caps winger Lou Franceschetti. First of all, give us the update on the injury. When can we expect to see you back in the lineup?
I just think it's a day-to-day thing right now. It's come along really well the last couple of days. I've been skating since Sunday. It's just a matter of getting the muscles used to skating right now. There's still a little bit of a bone bruise right now. With me, it's the most important thing is the first three steps, and I still can't get them off as quick as I'd like to.
Obviously, it pains you to sit out any game, but particularly against this New York Islander team. Is it safe to say that your performance against the Islanders a few years back in the playoffs may have been the key to get you another chance with the Capitals and the National Hockey League?
It was, because at that time, there was nobody really banging anybody. I just came out and I played more with emotion than anything. I wasn't scared to go through people, and I think that's what they were really liked about. I played my first game at home, and I remember just running Denis Potvin a couple of times. The crowd got on with me, and since then, I've been here.
You talk about playing with emotion. It seems lately, Lou, that is something the Capitals seem to be lacking a bit, and it's kind of puzzling with all that's at stake and the time of year it is. What do you see has been going wrong with the team lately in terms of the performances?
I just think we're not making the safe play right at this moment. During that stretch, we were really hot. Right after the All-Star break, we were making a simple play. Everything was in flow. It seems now like the forwards, the defense, and the goalies, we're just not in sync. There's a large gap between the forwards and the defensemen, and you can't have that in this league, because sometimes when they get puck, it's intercepted. It's an easy 3-on-2 on your defense, and right now we're just not making the easy and safe play.
You also mentioned playing the New York Islanders and going after a guy like Denis Potvin. What is your feeling about a guy like Potvin? He has meant a lot to the National Hockey League, and yet you have been bitter rivals with him. I remember you were one of the guys who went after him after he took Bengt Gustafsson out of the playoffs for the Washington Capitals late in the regular season a couple years ago. Do you have kind of mixed emotions about a guy like Denis Potvin?
I don't have no mixed emotions at all about him. He's a great defenseman. I think he's destined for the Hall of Fame right now. And it was just one of those things with Gustafsson. I thought that we were on the prime of going to the Stanley Cup Finals that year. We were on a roll, and it was the thing that he had done, sticking his leg out. I guess there was no cause for it, and I just had to put it in my own hands and just do something about it, try to pick the team up at that time. It was nothing against him sticking his leg out. It's just that we needed a pickup during that game.
All right, Lou, I know the fans in Washington like to see you, but would be much happier to see you back on the ice, and we hope that comes through soon. And for being our intermission guest, Lou Franceschetti receives a $50 gift certificate from Dash's Designer Menswear. We'll return with more intermission activity after these messages on your superstation, DC 20.
I don't have to worry about Track Auto's quality. It's there. I can concentrate on what I do best.
Bowling lesson?
Oh, Fred, you're up.
Your car will run smoother with Mobile Super Motor Oils, just 46 cents a quart. Or Rubber Queen four-piece carpeted car mats are just $12.49 a set. And would you believe Motorcraft spark plugs are 29 cents each for regulars or 39 cents each for resistors.
If you need it, Track's got it.
I bring your arm back like this for the release.
Like this?
Track Auto.
Most cars are designed specifically to handle this, the sales curve. The BMW 325 IS is influenced by curves of a slightly different nature. Before you choose a car engineered for the whims of the marketplace, consider one designed for undulations of a far more relevant variety.
Test drive the ultimate driving machine at your Washington area BMW dealers.
The signs are coming. Signs foretold for 2,000 years.
There's a whole chain of signs. The Bible's filled with them. It's about the apocalypse.
The birth of a child without a soul will be the seventh sign.
He thinks that he can
don't kill the baby, he'll end the world. Stay away.
If she can save her child, she can save us all. Demi Moore in The Seventh Sign. Rated R.
Starts tomorrow. Check newspapers for local listings.
Another 30 seconds of common sense.
The lowest-priced four-door sedan in America versus the closest competitor. Here, the very sensible Hyundai Excel at just $59.95. Reclining bucket seats, wall-to-wall carpeting, loaded with standard features. But, to be honest, the second lowest-priced four-door has all this and more. Lucky for us, it's also at your Hyundai dealer. The XL GL.
Test drive a durable Hyundai XL at your Washington-area Hyundai dealer. We sell cars that make sense.
Goaltender Kelly Rudy's mastery over the Washington Capitals continues in this first period. Even though the Capitals outshot the New York Islanders 14-5, they trail New York 2-0 on the scoreboard with goals from Makela and Gilbert for the Islanders. We'll return with more intermission activities after these words on DC 20.
Oh, Nino, let's find some nice music, and then it's time for your nappy.
Let's rock and roll.
Black slack. One little atom, I'm perking now.
And, ooh, that is nice.
Time to go to the back of the rack. Every big man, bold man, bulky man.
Changing the way Washington talks, it's the Grease Man. Mornings on DC 101.
Hey, Evan!
The real plus has arrived. The plus of high performance. The plus of high octane. The plus with Tecraleap, the cleansing additive tested 20 million miles, now in an unleaded gasoline that's far from regular. New Chevron Plus unleaded. It's the real plus you've been waiting for.
When it comes to autofocus cameras, some give you part of the action, but Canon EOS gives you all of the action. When it's so dark that some can't focus, EOS doesn't miss a trick. And Canon EOS has computers and motors in every lens for fast focus. So great shots are easy and so creative, the competition is out of the picture. EOS, more than autofocus, easier than ever. Buy EOS today with no money down, low monthly payments at participating Canon dealers.
All right. Name the fast food restaurant that serves burgers and fried chicken.
Fries. It's Roy's. Where do they get these people?
Now at Roy's, get a two-piece chicken dinner medium fries or a bacon cheeseburger medium fries. Your choice. Just $1.99.
I'll take Underwater Farming for 50.
I'll take Roy's for $1.99.
It's a 2-0 lead for the New York Islanders over the Washington Capitals after one period of play here in New York tonight. Mike Forns and Al Koken welcoming you back once again to our live exclusive coverage here on DC 20. Well, you talked about Kelly Hrudey and his mastery over the Capitals. It has been at times short-lived. We'll see if the Caps can get back in the game and put an end to that mastery, because in the first period, he sure made some big saves, including one at the very last second that I'm sure he's feeling right now in that collarbone.
Well, you know, we'll see if the Capitals can climb back in that regard. They did the right thing in terms of, after that early Islander explosion, kept New York kind of at bay, but to fall behind that early, those first 5 minutes, such a key in any game, but a big one like this with so much emotion on the Islander team and in this crowd, and they fall asleep for 30 seconds and it could really cost them.
We'll talk more about tonight's first period, but first, other scores from other games. Let's take a look at what's happening out of town and the other games around the National Hockey League. First of all, Quebec is at Philadelphia, and it's now 3-2. The Nordiques have the lead over the Flyers, and they're in the second period of the game. New Jersey is now trailing Pittsburgh 2-1. The Devils have jumped out to a 1-0 lead, but the Penguins come back with two goals of their own. Montreal is up 1-0 on the Boston Bruins at the Boston Garden. That game is in the second period. And also in the second period at Buffalo, it is Hartford 2 and Buffalo 2. The way those scores have been changing so far tonight, it looks like it could be any type of result by the evening's end, and it provides an infinite number of combinations and possibilities for the playoffs.
You know, we talked about Quebec and a lot of people saying the Flyers have the easy task because the Nordiques have been eliminated. That may prove out to be true, but there's a couple factors we talked about. The one, the relaxed team, a team that now has really nothing to care for, so they can play relaxed, and the Flyers have a lot of pressure on them. And the other thing is, everybody hates the Flyers, so you'll still get up for Philadelphia, and Ron LaPointe behind the bench knows that Philadelphia team from his days here with the Washington Capitals, so that could work in the favor of the Islanders and then Washington as well.
All right, we'll have tonight's second period between the Capitals and the Islanders after we return from these words.
This bud's for all that you do. You got a long road back. You missed the cheers. Can you beat those doubts and fears? You make America work.
For that something that won't let us quit, the clean, crisp taste of Beechwood-aged Budweiser.
To your first game back.
This bud's for you.
We're a team, my dad and me. There's a lot to do around the house, you see. Switch the switches, fix the door, and make a lot of trips to the trustworthy store. When we're stuck, they help us out with all the stuff we don't know about. My dad trusts the problem solver, and I trust my dad.
Trustworthy saves you time and problem solvers.
All right. Name the fast food restaurant that serves burgers and fried chicken.
Roy's. It's Roy's.
Where do they get these people?
Now at Roy's, get a two-piece chicken dinner medium fries or a bacon cheeseburger medium fries. Your choice. Just $1.99.
I'll take underwater farming for $50.
I'll take Roy's for $1.99.
Even with all you spend to keep your home beautiful, you may be overlooking something. Termites, destroying your house from the inside out. Call Orkin.
You know, for about the price these people are having to pay to fix this one door frame, we can protect your whole house so this never happens. Let Orkin inspect your house. We'll even do it for free if you call Orkin today. Free. Call number one. For termites, we just might be all the protection you'll ever need.
He survived Vietnam, has a black belt in Aikido. Meet Nico, a cop with an attitude. Above the Law, rated R. Special sneak preview Saturday, April 2nd.
Tonight's Capitals hockey game is brought to you in part by the Masonry Institute. Watch out, Washington, brick and block are back. By K Jewelers, the Diamond People. By Safeway. By Toyota. There's quality, and then there's Toyota quality. Who could ask for anything more? And by Buick. The great American roads lead to your Washington area Buick dealers.
Welcome back to the Nassau Coliseum. It's the Islanders 2 and the Washington Capitals nothing, and Brian Murray wasting no time in making a change in goal. Clint Malarchuk, who had five shots in the first period, made three saves and gave up two goals, has been pulled, and now Pete Peters comes in. Peters, entering the game for his 34th appearance of the year, has a goals against average of 2.71. He has 14 wins, 11 losses, and four ties with two shutouts. He's given up 81 goals in 1,791 minutes. Usually, we've seen Pete Peters depart because of illness frequently this year, and Malarchuk's been the man who comes on. This way, the other way around, Malarchuk out of there, and Peters now the man for the Capitals.
Well, the Capitals were a bit undecided on which goaltender to go with. They didn't make the decision until right before game time. Can't fault Malarchuk much on that second goal, but I think the first goal probably could have been stopped, and when you look at the difference in that, you give the team that first goal, they get a lift. Hrudey at the other end makes some big saves on good capital shots, and just the difference there. But I also think this is a message to the players in front: you better start playing a little tighter, no matter who is in that goal.
We're underway here with the second period, and the puck cleared off the sideboards for Gustafsson, and now Murphy, a slap shot that's deflected, and it sails up into the seats. Update you again on the out-of-town scores. Dan Quinn and Dan Frawley have also scored for Pittsburgh, and now they have tied up the Devils. Kirk Muller has scored for New Jersey, so it's now 2-2 in that game between Pittsburgh and New Jersey at the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh. Devils had a 1-0 lead on a goal by Bruce Driver. Then the Pens jumped out with two of their own. Now New Jersey's come back and tied it up. Right here, it's 2-0 Islanders. Mikko Makela starts out with a lead pass for Greg Gilbert. He's hooked to the ice by Mike Gartner. Took him down to one knee. And there'll be a penalty call here against Gartner for hooking. And that will give the Islanders the man advantage. Well, they're going to call it high sticking now by Gartner. Time of the call, 45 seconds of the second period. There's a break in the action. The Islanders lead the Capitals 2-0.
I don't know how many million calls people make every day on CNP. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Because when I pick up the phone, it works like I'm the only one using it.
It's for you.
The Capital penalty killers being called on once again. Gartner in the box for high sticking, 45 seconds into period number two. He gets the stick in there underneath the arm and up there around the face of Greg Gilbert. But a big hit from Konroyd was what really opened things up as he dropped Mike Ridley, and the New York Islanders able to counterattack and get some pressure, forcing Gartner to use the stick to slow Gilbert down.
Here's Hatcher from the faceoff, clears it back to the point. It's kept in. Morrow over to Jonsson. Jeff Norton, rather, on the left point. Back to Jonsson, a slap shot wide of the goal. LaFontaine pokes it right in front, and Peters reaches out and grabs it as LaFontaine is moved out of there by Rod Langway.
And Hatcher and Derek King also getting the sticks up. They were battling in front. This is not the situation I would imagine Pete Peters wants to see right off the bat. You'd like to get a couple shots at even strength before you have to face the New York Islander power play. But at least it seems like the Capitals are a little more intent on moving people out. Hatcher getting in there with King. And you see LaFontaine being taken care of by Langway to try and keep that slot area clean and at least let Pete Peters, if he's going to face some shots, let them be from the perimeter up on the point and let him get a pretty clear look at it.
Al, Dale Henry did not come out on the ice when the Islanders came out for the start of the second period. He just has rejoined the team, just coming out of the runway, and has gone straight to the New York bench. So he is again available for duty after suffering that hit from Stevens back in the first period. Islander power play continues. Jonsson a drive, a save. Peters hangs on to it, and the puck knocked in. The play had already been whistled down, and there's no goal. The red light goes on after Peters had stopped it. There's going to be a penalty call coming against Washington. The play had already been stopped on a high-sticking penalty, and Kevin Hatcher gets the call. The puck came loose after the whistle blew.
You see Rod Langway talking to Dale Hunter. You know, the Caps, again, kind of a bit out of rhythm in that defensive end. That box kind of pulled out, and you see Hatcher with the stick up there and then really whacks Pat LaFontaine in front. That looked to me like that, unless McCreary had blown the whistle to say that the puck was frozen, that penalty came after that puck was loose and rolling towards the cage. But apparently McCreary had blown the whistle to freeze things off. So a good news, bad news situation for the Caps. The goal does not count, but they lose Kevin Hatcher. And now for the next minute, 30 seconds, we'll be down two men, 5-on-3 hockey for the New York Islanders.
Gartner still has a minute 30 left on his call and a full 2 minutes put on the clock now to Kevin Hatcher. High sticking at 1:15 of the second period. The Islanders have Trottier out there along with Sutter, Makela, LaFontaine at the point with Potvin. Stevens is on for Washington with Langway and Gustafsson, the lone man up front. Trottier cuts in, fires. Peters makes the pad save and covers up.
Updating that game with the Flyers and the Quebec Nordiques, Murray Craven of Philadelphia has just scored, so the contest now at the Spectrum is tied up at 3-all. 1:17 left in the Gartner penalty, 1:47 left in the Hatcher call. It's Stevens, Langway, and Gustafsson for the Capitals. Trottier in the faceoff against Bengt Gustafsson for the New York Islanders.
Isles get the draw. Here's Potvin over to LaFontaine. He one times it wide. Now chase to the point. Potvin can't keep it in. Gustafsson breaks free. Shorthanded. Hustling in. He's pulled down but took a bit of a jump. And Bill McCreary will call it a penalty. There's a break for Washington. Gustafsson was definitely hooked on the play, but not badly enough to pull him down. And he took a quick jump off of his skates. But it fooled McCreary.
It was
that's a real break for Washington there. That cuts down that manpower advantage to a one-man advantage.
Islanders should be upset, but that is a smart play by Gustafsson. You know, in a situation like this, when your team's already down two men, you get any kind of little opportunity, make sure you go down in that part. He's not going to be caught out of position. It won't hurt. And in that case, you can maybe get the call. It works here for the Capitals. They get a little more breathing space. Now watch how quickly Gustafsson goes down. Just a little contact with the stick, and Bengt Gustafsson reacts dramatically and then gets back up quickly. Interesting, too, Mike, how frustrating you can see for the players. The other night with Mike Noah, the referee, masters of using the stick to slow people down were the Detroit Red Wings, and the Capitals certainly joined in. Now we've seen some stick restraint, one by Gartner, here by Gustafsson, and penalties called. It's tough to go night after night and really know what you can get away with in the National Hockey League.
Here's LaFontaine starting out to Norton. Racing down the middle as Makela drops it off for Pat LaFontaine. Passed over and an easy score for Trottier, who had all kinds of net to shoot at. Gustafsson was way out of the play. There were only two Capitals in front. And New York takes a power play goal lead of 3-0.
Bengt Gustafsson is so good defensively, but here's a situation where he just would have been well advised to drop back in. He's trying to make the spectacular play, try and force LaFontaine, but here's a guy in LaFontaine who is a master at controlling the puck in tight situations. At that point, it then becomes 3-on-2, and LaFontaine makes the great pass. He's come in the zone now. You've got the two Capital defensemen lined up with him. There was plenty of room for Trottier, and he made no mistake. Pete Peters could not get over. You can't fault him there. In a situation like that, when you got three men out there, you really got to take the safe route in that regard.
It's Trottier's 30th goal of the year from LaFontaine. And Mikko Makela at 201.
Trottier's 30th of the year from LaFontaine and Makela. Power play goal at 201.
Here's Murphy back into his own end now for Washington. Over to Scott Stevens. Stevens brings it ahead to center ice for Murphy. Murphy gets across the line. Over at the right point, gives it to Ridley. Ridley back again to Larry Murphy. Murphy's wrist shot missing high and wide off the glass. Now Kerr starts out. Flips to center. Konroyd dumps it in. Stevens goes to the corner. And Gartner comes out with a puck. Mike Gartner starts to his own line. Stick handles to center ice. Gartner inside the Islander zone. New York leads 3-0. Wrist shot by Gartner caught easily by Hrudey. He puts it behind the net. Here comes Jonsson to start out. Tomas Jonsson. Capitals in a line change. Jonsson to the Washington line. Over to Bassen. His wrist shot blocked by Scott Stevens. Bassett into the corner. Stevens takes over. Leads a pass ahead for Larry Murphy. Murphy at the blue line. Good pass to Stevens. Cuts in. Can't get the shot away. We have a penalty call coming up. A delayed call against New York. Kerr and Stevens push and shove. There is a penalty call coming already against New York. And let's see if Stevens is going to get anything or not. I don't think so, so far.
Scott Stevens makes a great play down the middle, but I like the one play made by that man, number 8, Norton, the rookie. He gets in there and really ties up Scott Stevens' stick. There will be an interference call coming to Alan Kerr, but that's a nice play by the rookie. Stevens, using the little room that he's given by David Christian. Slashing is the call to Kerr, but Norton, the rookie, makes a nice play, and then Scott, a bit frustrated and angry at Norton for that play, pops him in the face. Kerr comes in there and gives something to Stevens, but it'll be Kerr, the only man penalized in that flurry. With this situation, the Capitals now will have the man advantage. It's time for our second Circuit City Power Play contest. Contestant number 2, Andy DeLuca of Annapolis, Maryland. Andy has chosen Dale Hunter as the Capitals player to score on the power play. If Hunter scores, Andy receives a video or stereo unit courtesy of Circuit City.
Only 1 second left in the penalty call to Hatcher. When Kevin comes out of the box, Potvin will have 30 seconds left on his call, and then Kerr with 2 minutes up there. So the Caps will enjoy a two-man advantage. Right now, it's a 4-on-3 situation. Hatcher's out of the box, and the Capitals are at full strength and a two-man advantage. Here's Gary Galley. Over to Kevin Hatcher. Caps 11th in the league on the power play at 20%. And the Islanders terrible at killing them off at 18th in the league, 77%. Those figures don't count on a goaltending display like Kelly Rudy's had tonight. At the point, here's Galley. Over to Christian. Cuts in front. Sends it on goal. The save made by Rudy. Played back to Galley. Potvin's out of the box. It's a one-man Capitals advantage. Right in front, it's cleared by Sutter and sent all the way down. The Caps were trying to get the puck over to Michael Pavonka, and it was intercepted. 16 minutes to play here in the second period. A minute 10 left on the Allen Kerr penalty. Here's Christian cutting into the corner. Throws it into the corner now for Pavonka. Pavonka back to Christian. Takes it behind the net. Stolen by Sutter. Galley takes it back. Gary Galley a shot. Hrudey catches it and hangs on.
Gary Galley had to get that shot off quickly. Really, he had no time to aim it. Puts it right in the midsection of Hrudey. Now, the Capitals, though, were frustrated by not getting anything down that middle. Everything is to the side, and look how the Islanders seal that slot area off. Galley does a good job of keeping things in, but there's just a terrific job done in the middle, and particularly by Brent Sutter. Watch this save. Capitals trying to get it over to Pavonka through the middle. Closed off right down the slot on that time by Brent Sutter. On that 5-on-3, Mike, the Capitals were trying to get something going with their high point man. Set them up in the middle and get the forwards on either side of the post. The Islanders wouldn't allow it. They kept the Capitals off to an angle, and that's the way you kill off a 5-on-3.
The Islanders clear it all the way down with 45 seconds to play in the Allen Kerr penalty. Washington trails the Islanders 3-0. Lead pass out to center ice for Mike Gartner. Hunter comes over to help him out. Gets it inside the New York zone. Now Kromm whips it back to center ice. Here's Scott Stephens. Drives it into the corner. Hrudey roadblocks behind the net, makes the play up the glass, and it's Ridley to keep it in now for Washington. Mike Ridley. Across the faceoff circle, a shot, a save, and the rebound bounces off the skate of Hunter. Played up the boards and out to center ice. 5 seconds left in Kerr's penalty. Here's Stevens back in his own end. Penalty's over to Kerr. Out of the box he comes. The Islanders at full strength. Kerr steals the puck. Flips it across the line. The Islanders in a line change, and Stevens goes back to get it. Penalty box is empty for the first time in a while. Here's Ridley. Out to Hunter. Stolen puck, Greg Gilbert, 3-on-1 with Kerr and LaFontaine. Shoot, save to Peters, and Stevens clears it up the boards for Ledyard. Up on the right wing, here's Gould. Now to Corriveau, wrist shot. That's sticked wide by Rudy. Back over to Hunter. He throws between the point men. It sails all the way down. Here's Langway. Out to Ledyard. Now to Michael Pavonka. He cuts to the line, drops it off. Gould a shot, saved by Rudy. A dazzling stop by Kelly Rudy. And he spears one of the Capitals in front as he felt some pressure to his left and reached out with that goal stick and took a hard chop with a stick right in the stomach of one of the Capitals. There's a break in the action with a score. The Islanders 3 and the Capitals nothing.
Those of you who've been postponing your dreams of owning a BMW, your BMW dealer brings a ray of sunshine. A congenial financing program. So you no longer have to put your dreams on hold. 6.9 APR financing available for a limited time. See your participating BMW dealer for details.
We're still waiting to see Bill McCreary make some calls. There's got to be something. A spear. Denis Potvin mugging Ivan Corriveau at the side, and Corriveau has been cut. Bobby Gould wanted to have something going with Kelly Rudy,
And right now, Bill McCurry has not made a move over towards the penalty bench. Be unbelievable if nothing comes out of this. The Islanders had a chance earlier to really break this game completely open and take it over. 3-on-1 as the Caps win a line change. Great save by Pete Peters. Scott Stevens does the right thing. He gives Peters the shooter and makes sure he's there for any kind of rebound and clears it out. Now watch this Capitals chance as it comes up. Hrudey makes a great save, but watch the mugging by Potvin and the spear by Hrudey. Here comes Ivan Korvo. There's the shot. Now it'll come back into action here. As Hunter digs it down in the corner, he'll send it out in front, and it's unbelievable that nothing has been called by Bill McCreary.
Back to live action now as the Capitals storm the net. A backhand shot by Hunter and a save made by Hrudey. The puck cleared out to center ice. Here's Langway. Backhands it inside the Islander zone. Trottier pokes it free. The whistle is blown. And now Hunter giving a shot over there against the sideboards as he got all tied up with Steve Konroyd. Now Makela gets a punch from Kevin Hatcher. Gartner gets in there and tries to hold one of the Islanders out of the fray, and they're going to put Hatcher in the box. No calls on what had happened earlier, as Al pointed out. Now Hatcher is being sent to the penalty box, and let's see if anybody else will go in too.
The Caps screaming that Makela better get in there. Well, it looked like really Kevin Hatcher was the guy who started to throw those first punches. Well, tickets for playoff games A and B are on sale now. The dates of the games dependent on the outcome of the Patrick Division race. If the Caps finish in first or second, games A and B will be the 6th and 7th of April at 7:30. Those are Wednesday and Thursday nights. If the Caps finish third or fourth, games A and B will be Saturday and Sunday, the 9th and 10th. At 7:30. Tickets available at all Hex ticket centers or by calling phone charge at 202-432-0200 or 1-800-448-9009. And tonight, operators will be on duty until 11 p.m. We'll try and sort out what's going on out there in the penalties after these messages on DC 20.
Kevin Hatcher is in the box for roughing at 6:23. The Islanders with a power play advantage and a 3-0 lead. The lone penalty given out of all that went to Kevin Hatcher. Here's LaFontaine to center ice. He's across the Washington line. Stevens slashes at LaFontaine, knocking the puck away, and the puck comes over now to King. His shot knocked down by the glove of Peters. Here's Scott Stevens in the corner. He's bumped hard, but Langway has it and leads it ahead to Kelly Miller. Hard-working Kelly Miller gets to center to the blue line, and his shot is deflected by Potvin and goes up into the crowd.
Denis Potvin has been in the middle of almost everything tonight. Now watch, this is where Ivan Korvo gets mugged. Now Bobby Gould takes the shot. Hrudey quickly makes the save, but you see Korvo going for the puck while it's in the air. Now watch this. Can you believe there's not going to be anything called there? It's fine to stand up for your goaltender in that regard, but with Kelly Hrudey then giving a spear and Potvin cutting Ivan Korvo in that exchange, that's where the tempers got up, and that's where Kevin Hatcher got involved. Although I certainly agree with Bill McCreary, what I saw, it looked like Kevin Hatcher definitely was trying to goad Mikko Makela into something and was the guy with the punches to the face of Makela. He deserved the roughing call.
Here's Stevens with the puck back at center ice. Gets to the Islander line. Offside is called. Trottier pulled him in. Some more goal scorers on those out-of-town games for Quebec, who are tied right now with Philadelphia 3-3. The Nordiques with goals from Lane Lambert, Jeff Brown, and Anton Stastny. Dave Poulin has two goals for the Flyers, and Murray Craven the other. Stevens back to center. Lofts it into the Islander zone. Tomas Jonsson back to pick it up. Lead pass to the blue line. Out to center ice comes Jeff Norton. He dumps it back inside the Washington zone. Trottier to the corner. Rubbed out by Langway. Now it's cleared back to the point. Kept in by Jonsson. And sent all the way down. Hrudey to the corner. Throws it over to Jeff Norton. Norton back of the net now for Jonsson. Jonsson leaves it in the corner and Trottier comes over to pick it up. He's being forechecked by Sundstrom and Gustafsson. The puck forced behind the goal. And Jonsson now to start out. Jonsson leads it ahead for Norton. Left wing side. Here comes Trottier across the Washington blue line. Drop pass for Jonsson. A slap shot just wide. It almost hit LaFontaine and might have gone in the net had it struck him in the arm. Hrudey again to move it up the boards for Jonsson. 8 seconds left in the Islander power play. Caps caught in a line change. Here comes a pass to LaFontaine. He scores! The Islanders taking advantage of the Capitals who get caught changing lines. Now they lead 4-0.
Bob Bassett is the man who enjoys all the room because, as Mike mentioned, the Capitals don't have all their bodies out. Scott Stevens trying to get back, but as everybody goes after Bassett, nobody has picked up LaFontaine, and it's another easy goal. It's just undisciplined, very, very careless hockey in that regard. When you start getting beaten on line changes, Mike, and giving up chances like that, you just are not working as a unit. You're not in sync. You're not thinking as a team. Of course, it's difficult. You're out there filling off those penalties. You try to get the fresh troops out there. And sometimes the timing is difficult. But Bob Bassett takes advantage of all that room and slides the perfect pass to LaFontaine. Just like LaFontaine that slid it over to Trottier when Bengt Gustafsson had committed. And the Cap just giving New York just too much room to maneuver.
Here's Gartner, a high drive, and that's deflected off the arm of Hrudey. And into the crowd. Bassen and Jonsson assisting LaFontaine at 8:20 of the second period. Pat LaFontaine's 47th goal of the year. And on the power play this season, that is his 15th goal with a man advantage.
Gartner trying to go up high, misses everything. Hrudey, the reflection goes way up into the crowd. And now we understand New Jersey has gone back ahead of the Pittsburgh Penguins on a John McLain goal. 3-2 is the lead for New Jersey.
Face off to the right of Hrudey. Ridley's on with Miller and Gartner. The draw back to Konroyd. Here's Jonsson ahead for Sutter. Bounces it back inside the Washington zone. Mike Gartner to pick it up. Flips it to center ice. Now Miller down the left wing. Tied up on the play by Konroyd. Alan Kerr starts back for New York up to center ice. Right wing pass, Brent Sutter. Sutter tries to flip it in front, but Greg Smith is there and sends it up the boards. Now Kerr directs it toward the net. Peters makes the stop. Put right in front of the goal, and Mike Gartner's there. He starts ahead to Kelly Miller. Here's Miller to the blue line. Inside the line, and he's hooked off his skates. There'll be a penalty call here against Alan Kerr as he fouled Mike Gartner. 2 minutes for interference at 9:30 of the second period. There's a break in the action with a score. The Islanders 4, the Capitals nothing.
Does car shopping confuse you? If you've shopped, and I have, you'll find the one place where the confusion ends is your Buick dealer. That's why I just bought a brand new Buick Regal. Regal is actually priced under T-Bird and Cougar. The new Regal just looks like it costs thousands more. So don't get confused. Shop where you like, but start at your Buick dealer. The car is Regal, but the price sure isn't.
Alan Kerr of the Islanders makes his third appearance in the penalty box tonight. First two for slashing. This one interference at 9:30, getting in the way of Mike Gartner, preventing him from catching up with that puck.
Well, Both Islander goals this period have been on the power play. If you look at the statistics, you would expect Washington to be taking advantage of the Islanders' poor penalty killing habits. New York leads 4-0. Here's a shot deflected, gets right in front. Hrudey makes the save, and Adams gets into a pushing match with Diddick. Stevens let fly with a drive from the point, and the deflection slowed it down just a bit to throw Hrudey off, but he was able to stay in front of it.
Perfect example of what both sides have to do. The Capitals have to generate something in front. You see the deflection, it comes through. Now Adams swings around to try and get in it. It's a late poke, but that's where Greg Adams is going to start having to set himself up. But give credit to Diddick. He's doing the job that he's got to do. Make sure Adams does not take any liberties with Kelly Hrudey.
Gustafsson works the draw against Sutter, wins it, brings it back to Scott Stevens. Over now to Bengt Gustafsson. Fakes the shot, lets it fly just wide. Christian was lurking at the side of the net, but couldn't get a stick on it. Now here comes Hatcher cutting in. A wrist shot. It's knocked down. I think it hit the stick of Adams. It goes wide to the corner for Scott Stevens. Here's Stevens over to Hatcher. Hatcher flips it in front. Adams gets a piece of it. Now Christian chases behind the net. Dave Christian for the Capitals to Gustafsson. Back to Hatcher. Adams in front, trying to distract Hrudey. But Hrudey makes a kick save. Now here's Stevens. Over again to Kevin Hatcher. 1:10 left on the Washington power play. Stevens at the left point. Islanders sending those men out high to try and defend against the point man, and it pays off. Christian forced down low, and the puck cleared all the way down. Islanders in a line change. Stevens to the Islander blue line. And Morrow steals and clears. Kevin Hatcher up the right wing for Gartner, and Potvin sends it to the line, and now we've got a whistle here, and I think a penalty against New York for too many men on the ice. I believe the Islanders may have been caught during that last line change. Yes, that's the call. And it happens with 43 seconds left in the call to Kerr. This penalty at 10:47 will give Washington another two-man advantage.
We still got half a hockey game to play, but the Capitals need to get something with this two-man advantage. They cannot continue to blow good opportunities to come back and get something scratched up on the board. They had an earlier two-man advantage that they got nothing on for 30 seconds. Now 43 seconds here. But with the Islanders doing the job killing off penalties on that last little flurry in the Islander end, had Greg Adams doing the work in front, but the rest of the Islander penalty killers kept forcing the play to the perimeter, out to the point, out along the boards, no passing down low to take advantage of Greg Adams in front.
Dale Henry will serve the penalty, Al, on the Islanders' behalf. Time of the call, 10:47. Washington with five skaters out there, the Islanders with three. Here's Ridley from the draw, gets across the line, finds Gartner open, but passes behind him. Now Hunter into the corner, loses his edge, passes it back to Ridley. Ridley to the point to Larry Murphy. Murphy over to Stevens, winds a slap shot, skate save to Hrudey, and the puck cleared all the way down. Hrudey never saw that shot, went right off his skate blade.
Came right back into traffic, nobody for the Capitals could control it.
Here's Murphy cutting in, feeds it over to Hunter. He puts it to Stevens, a shot, and a goal! Scott Stevens lining up the deflection pass right in front, and the Capitals use that power play to get on the board at 4-1.
There you go. That's what you needed to get yourself established. They still have 1:26. Now watch Stevens. He'll make the play, and then with everybody kind of lined up over towards that right side, watch how he sneaks in behind. He beats Denis Potvin in there. You've got that two-on-one situation. You've got plenty of men to work with, but the Capitals finally take advantage. Give Larry a lot of credit to that man, Larry Murphy. He makes a nice little pass to get Hunter for a better angle facing the goal, and Scott Stevens alertly recognizing what's going on and takes the maneuver, beating Denis Potvin to the play and to the net for the deflection. It finally gets something going for the Capitals. After two periods of play at the Spectrum in Philadelphia, Michel Goulet has put the Nordiques back on top, this time 4-3 over the Flyers. Now, Brian Murray has taken a timeout, an important timeout. You've got a minute 26. If you get on the board again here, Mike, you've still got half a hockey game to go, and you've cut the deficit to two, and you've got some momentum going your way. But it's important, at least if they don't score, for the Capitals to continue to push the attack here. But a goal here changes the complexion of this game completely.
Scott Stevens, 12th of the year, from Larry Murphy and Dale Hunter at 11:21 on the power play. Henry still with a minute 20 to go on the Islander bench penalty, and here comes Christian to center ice. Over to Stevens. Scott Stevens carries it in to Hunter on the left wing. Cuts to the net. Can't get the shot off. Morrow's all over him. Now it's played to the corner for Gustafsson. Back to Murphy. Over to Scott Stevens. It hops off his stick and comes to center ice. Plays it back to the Islander line, and Morrow sends it all the way down. Here's Stevens back in his own zone. Now to Christian. Right wing pass for Larry Murphy. He dumps it in the Islander end. Gustafsson to the corner. Jams up. Christian alongside tries to work it free, but Morrow sends it the length of the ice. 30 seconds to go in the Washington power play. Here's Gustafsson into the Islander zone for Murphy. Larry Murphy at the right point, a slap shot that's popped up and sails into the crowd.
21 seconds remaining in that Islander bench minor for too many men on the ice that's being served by Dale Henry. Maybe that assist will get Larry Murphy going. He'd only had one goal and one assist in his last 12 games, and he said made a nice play to get the puck to Hunter, who had the good angle to find Scott Stevens. The Capitals need production from Larry Murphy. They've got to get him on track.
He hasn't been playing with any confidence at all over perhaps the last 10 to 12 games, and tonight has looked markedly better. He's been moving the puck. He's been playing like he has some confidence. Here's a drive by Ledyard that's tipped wide. Now back to Hatcher at the right point. Over to Ledyard. Down the middle it goes to Ridley, and he goes rink wide for Gartner, but it's intercepted. Ridley chases it up the boards, but Hatcher gets it. Back to Mike Ridley. Ridley to Hatcher. Into the corner, and Miller goes in with Potvin. They take a spill. The puck is loose, and it's underneath Kelly Miller. And the whistle stops play, and that ends the penalty. To Dale Henry, he's back on the ice. 7:04 to go in the second period, and now both clubs are at full strength.
But let's see if the Capitals can continue with some momentum, continue to push some of the attack. Ledyard with the drive. Good save again by Hrudey, particularly because of the screen and the distraction provided right in front by Kelly Miller. From right behind the net, this is a perfect shot from Ledyard. Pretty low, something that Miller almost could have handled, but once again, Kelly Hrudey commits and goes out, really gambles there, kind of takes himself out of position, but Capitals haven't been able to take advantage of many of those loose pucks and rebounds in that regard.
LaFontaine against Pavanka. Islanders get the draw. Konroyd over to Jonsson. Back to Konroyd. He works to center ice. Dumps it back into the Washington zone. Peters plays it for Langway. Rod pressured by two Islander forecheckers. Throws it up the right wing side now for Christian. He flips to center ice. Here's Pavanka. Gets it to Korovo, and he throws it into the Islander end. Konroyd backboards the pass over to Gilbert. He's bumped by Korovo, and the puck sent the length of the ice. Langway trying to get there first and does. Icing is the call. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders 4 and the Capitals 1.
Mr. Dave Christian for Provident Savings.
If you think offsides and two-line passes are hard to understand, you should try asking a banker about mortgage rates. Unless, of course, you're asking for a Provident Savings mortgage. They have so many rates and terms, you can almost pick your own and get it fast. At Providence, you get the loan you need, not just something off the shelf. At Providence, we all wear one number, number one.
Providence Savings, member FSLIC.
We're back with 6:30 to go in this second period. The 4-1 lead for the Islanders. Keep an eye on number 7, Gilbert, and number 26, Ivan Korvo. These two guys were going at it, trying to get at each other before the whistle blew. Linesman Bob Hodges had gotten between them. And there you see again the dominance on the shot clock. Almost in all the Caps Islander games, Washington is badly outshot. the New York Islanders, but don't have a lot to show for it in terms of total wins, and certainly not here, down 4-1.
Gilbert brings it back to Jonsson behind the Islander net. Konroyd out to center. It sails all the way down. Langway back for it. This will be icing, and the Islander fans thought that Langway would have been able to play that puck, but the officials disagreed.
You can guarantee yourself the best seat available for all the Cap Home playoff games. Just put down a deposit on a season ticket or partial plan for next year. It entitles you to purchase the best available ticket to all the Cap Home playoff games. If you'd like more information, sales rep, stand by right now at 386-7000. That's 386-7000.
.6:15 to go here in the second period. Michael Pavanka to work against Pat LaFontaine. LaFontaine beats him, brings it back to Jonsson, but back of the net, Pavanka steals, tries to center, and Hrudey plays it back to the corner. Up the boards, Randy Wood taken out and gets away from Langway. Here's Gilbert charging into the Washington zone. High stick by Hatcher and nothing called. Here's Jonsson faking, walking in. Can't get by, and Pavanka breaks free. The Caps got a break there. Here's a 3-on-2 now for Washington in across the line. Here's Bobby Gould, a shot and a goal! Bobby Gould with a big comeback play, taking advantage of a 3-on-2 break. And the Capitals back in this game at 4-2.
There's some of that momentum I was talking about. Even though they didn't get it on the power play with that second penalty after scoring on the 5-on-3, the Capitals continued to put some pressure on Hrudey. But the big break, though, Mike, was the play that was not called down on Kevin Hatcher. And the Capitals were able to take advantage. That was Jonsson rushing the puck. So right there, you've got one of the defensemen out. A forward has to come back, and that is Gilbert. They've got two people tied up, but the third man is free, Bobby Gould, and he makes the play. Capitals with a transition game as Jonsson caught in on the rush, and the Caps took advantage 3-on-2 and made it pay off with that third man scoring the goal, Bobby Gould.
It's Gould's 12th of the year from Pavanka at 14-15. New York 4, Washington 2. Here's another rush inside the Islander zone, and Norton picks it up. And it bounced off Larry Murphy. Here comes Kerr to start out to center ice. Left wing pass. In across the line. Bassen's pass is blocked. It goes back to Kerr. Now to the point for Norton. To Alan Kerr. He shoots wide of the net. Sundstrom moves it back to his own line, and Bassen ties up there with Mike Gartner. They both take a spill. Here's Norton. Up for Kerr. Stolen puck. Lead pass for Hunter from Sundstrom. A shot. Hrudey makes the pad save. Now Morrow behind the net. Over to Norton. Norton headmans up the middle. The Capitals in a line change. Here comes Bassen. Drops it off for Curry. Fires. It hit Peters on the deflection. Rode right up into his face mask. And Pete was able to keep it in front of him and stops play. Now Hunter and Kerr get the sticks up. Greg Smith along the side of the Washington net starts pushing and shoving in there with Bassen. And there may be penalties coming to those two for continuing their actions after the play had been whistled down.
At one end, a stop by Kelly Hrudey. Peter Sundstrom gets the puck over to Dale Hunter. Hunter with a little bit of a step on that left wing. Winds up from the top of the faceoff circle. Very coolly played by Kelly Hrudey, coming out and making the pad save. Then action at the other end. Watch Bob Bassen sailing in there. The deflection is stopped by Pete Peters. Bassen tries to get in there. Kerr also bumps Greg Smith. And that's where all the sticks, the roughing plays come in, and penalties to Bassen and Smith because of it.
Roughing penalties at 15-21. To both Greg Smith of the Capitals and Bob Bassen of the Islanders. We're underway once again. No manpower advantage for either side. Peters makes a stop. The puck is loose. We have a penalty call coming. A minor for holding. This is going to be against Washington. Gustafsson has lost his stick, but I think Gustafsson is going to get the penalty. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders 4 and the Capitals 2.
Bad night. Do you need to save money?
No matter what your station in life, it's smart to save money on automotive necessities at Track Auto.
Do you need to save time?
Young men like myself like to spend their leisure time in places somewhat more romantic than an engine department.
If you need low, low prices, if you need a warranty, if you need it, Track's got it.
I just do what I do.
Track Auto.
It's holding on Bengt Gustafsson at 15:30. Lost the stick, grabbed a hold of Bryan Trottier in front. Is called for it by Bill McCreary. Take a look at the action. The shot coming in from the point. Now Gustafsson has lost the stick. Knocked out of the hand. You see him, he's just holding on to Trottier's stick. I guess he still had it in his right hand, then dropped it, but holding on to the stick like that.
Here's Trottier into the corner. Brings it back to the point for Jonsson. Now over to Trottier. Back to the corner man, Mikko Makela to the point. Jonsson a blast. He scores! A deflection goal that I think went off a Washington player. Now it's the Islanders 5 and the Capitals 2. On the power play goal with Gustafsson in the box.
Well, the frustration Brian Murray's got to feel when you see it, it looks like the Capitals are in a good defensive position. If you're a goaltender, this is pretty much what you want. It looks like it's a clear view in that box, thrown back out to Jonsson. Watch Kelly Millard. Is he the man who gets the piece of the puck, or is it right there on Kevin Hatcher? That's who it is. Hatcher gets that second puck, and it really lifts itself up in that corner. Right there, Kevin Hatcher trying to do something to play it. Looked like Peters was going to be able to see it all the way if Hatcher hadn't gotten the stick in the body there. A pretty clear shot, which a goaltender wants. When you get out there and you're playing at that close in, and the way the puck has already been moving up high anyway, it's awful tough to stop a puck like that. Instead, it just changes its direction, and that great comeback the Capitals had made with the two goals maybe going for naught as the Islanders capitalize on their third power play tally.
Still awaiting the announcement on the goal of Jonsson that has given the Islanders a 5-2 lead. It's Jonsson's sixth of the year.
The assist to number 24, Mikko Makela, and number 19, Bryan Trottier. The time of the goal, 15:46.
Makela and Trottier get the assist at 15:46. As Jonsson scores on the power play, his sixth goal of the season. Capitals down by 3. Ledyard dumps it back inside the New York zone. Here's Kromm to go after it. He's bumped by Christian, still has the puck, and leads it out to center ice for Randy Wood. Wood across the blue line. Into the corner, Stevens can't hang on to him. Wood circles the net, brings it back to the point. Norton's drive is wide, didn't get all of it. And back comes Stevens to play it to Pavunka. He flips it out to center ice. Norton dumps it back into the corner. The Islanders changing on the fly. Pavunka rubbed out against the sideboards, but throws it to the Islander line. Here comes Potvin working ahead. Right wing side for Makela. Flips it into the corner, just missing Trottier. The Caps come out. Here's Ridley inside the New York zone. Washington with a line change underway. Murphy goes to the corner. Now it's taken away. Here comes Potvin. Leads it ahead. Gilbert in. Fires. Peters the save. Over to Greg Adams. Adams puts it behind the net for Larry Murphy. 2.5 minutes to go here in the second period. And the puck shot into the Islander bench out of play. Well, the Capitals have taken the least amount of penalty minutes per game this year among all the National Hockey League teams, 20.9 penalty minutes per game, and the Islanders are the next least penalized team at 21.7 penalty minutes per game. A But power plays have sure played a big role in this contest, haven't they?
Well, you'd expect, despite the fact that those two teams are the least penalized teams in the National Hockey League, with all the emotion riding on this game, you'd see more penalties than normal between the two clubs. We've seen a lot of high sticking and roughing, but it's that last one that may really prove to be the backbreaker, a holding call. And Bengt Gustafsson just grabbing onto the stick. Sometimes you can get away with it, but right there in front of the net, it's always going to attract more attention, and Bill McCreary was there to make the proper call. And you come back, you make a little bit of momentum swing your way, and then you lose it quickly on the power play.
Here's a wrist shot just wide of the Washington goal. Into the corner goes Kerr. Larry Murphy back to play it. Kicks it away from Bassen and takes it from behind the net. Out to center ice for Ridley. Knocked down by Bassett. Taken over by Gary Galley of the Capitals. He throws it inside the Islander zone. Here's Konroyd to go pick it up. Ridley tries to keep it inside the line. Finally, it comes back to Washington ice for Larry Murphy. Here's Murphy ahead for Greg Adams. Right wing pass misses Hunter. It goes into the corner. Here's Konroyd back to get it. He's rubbed out by Gartner. Tried to pass in front for Adams, but the pass stolen. And Jonsson plays it out to center ice. Now Galley dumps it back in. Hrudey road blocks behind the net. Leaves it there for Bob Bassen. Off the boards, it's cleared all the way down. It'll be icing against New York as Murphy goes back to pick it up. We're down to 1:24 left to play here in the second period. Four power play goals coming here in second period action, with the Islanders getting three of them. Washington coming up with back-to-back goals by Scott Stevens and Bob Gould. Stevens' scoring play was while Washington had a man advantage. But when Tomas Jonsson deflected one off Kevin Hatcher into the net, that got the Islanders back into a three-goal lead.
Expect to see this man's jersey up there in the rafters with all those championship banners, and he has been one of the major reasons that there are all those banners here at the Nassau County Coliseum. 14 years of the Patrick Division, only the Flyers and the New York Islanders have won division championships, and that is something the Capitals were gunning for. They announced it from the start of the season. They want something in that Capitol Center.
Here's a shot taken by Langway. That's knocked down, and it's picked up by Norton. He starts to center ice. Norton throws it back inside the Washington zone, and Langway goes back to get it. Throws it behind the net. Here's Wood trying to flip it in front, but Hunter's right there. He sends it off the glass all the way back into the Islander zone. We're in the final minute of play here in the second period. Rookie Jeff Norton out of the University of Michigan starts ahead for Wood. Randy Wood across the line, a wrist shot caught by Peters. He finds Korovo on the left wing. Ivan Korovo back to the Islander line. Now Potvin sends it up the middle and all the way down. A race for it. LaFontaine and Hatcher go back, but Peters elects to play it over to Langway. Korovo to Sundstrom. Dumps it back into New York ice. 25 seconds to go in the second period. Here's Potvin. Off the boards into the legs of Makela, and Pavanka tries to work it free. Now back to Miller. Over to Pavanka. Pavanka winds, fires. Hrudey the save, and he covers up right in front to stop play.
It's another low shot, but this time Kelly Hrudey doesn't let that rebound get out too far. Pavanka tries to get it away quickly. The stop, the puck loose for a second. And Kelly Hrudey covers quickly as he does have some help. Stopping himself and getting that low drive away, but look right there is Denis Potvin. You see Diduck coming in there as well to clear traffic, getting Sundstrom away. That's the perfect combination. You get that goaltender to, he makes that first stop, you should have defensemen right there to help him with the traffic, help him clear that puck.
Al, I agree with you when you say that Denis Potvin's sweater should be retired in this building, and if it happens, and it most certainly will happen, but when it does, it'll be the first of the Islander sweaters to ever be retired, and I think there are a few more coming along the line.
Well, number 19 is going to go right up there as soon as that happens, and
number
I would 22 also
22 as well.
And 22, and I'm also going to add Billy Smith, of course, to that category, although he seems to be involved in kind of a contact dispute, which would seem a shame for all the great years he's played for the New York Islanders not to finish his career here.
Here's Sutter with the puck, shovels it out of the zone back to the Washington end, and as time runs out, the Islanders coming up with a big second period. The Capitals get two on the board, but New York scores three times, and they hold a three-goal lead of 5-2. Shots on goal in the second period. Washington coming up with 17, and the Islanders 9, and it now stands at the Capitals 31 and the Islanders 14. Our live exclusive coverage continues in a moment from the Nassau Coliseum after these messages here on DC 20.
Come from working on Tatum Beach. I try to make some supper, but I can't even eat. Jump in the shower, watch the world from my back. Gotta get you, baby, that's a natural fact. It's the night time. That's the right time.
Mr. Burns, what's your secret?
Clean living, Frankie.
And Amoco Ultimate for a clean engine?
I hate dirty engines. I'm not funny, but I'm neat.
Come on, Mr. Burns, what do you know about gasoline?
Cigars and women I know, gasoline my car knows.
Most gasolines clean fuel injectors, but pure Amoco Ultimate cleans your entire fuel intake system.
George, should we make this cash or credit?
At my age, you better make it cash. Did that excite you?
Are you waiting for your big, handsome prince to come along? Well, you could wait forever. But if you go to Ritz Camera and get your film developed, you can get your big prince within an hour. They're 37% bigger than normal prints, and they really do look smashing. Of course, there is another way to get your big, handsome prince within an hour. You can go kiss a toad. Get the Ritz Big Print. In 1 hour, you'll never go back to slow again.
Swing into spring with style and savings during Dash's early spring sale. Save 40 to 60% off everything in stock. Poly wool designer suits, $189. Poly cotton designer dress shirts are 3 for $35. Poly wool designer dress pants with knee lining, a mere $45. Poly cotton designer golf shirts are now 3 for $33. It's Dash's early spring sale, where you'll save 40 to 60% off everything in stock.
Hi, everybody. I'm Jeff McGregor, reminding you there's been a change in plans. Begin your late-night rendezvous with the all-new dating game beginning April 4th at 11 on DC 20.
Power plays certainly were the story in the second period. The New York Islanders scored three times with the extra man. The Capitals finally got on the board with a power play opportunity, but the Islanders again controlling that period. They've increased their lead to three over the Washington Capitals. It's now a 5-2 hockey game. Welcome back to Capitals Hockey on DC 20. Al Koken with you at the Nassau County Coliseum. As we've talked about, tonight is the last regular season appearance for Denis Potvin. Some people at the Capitol Center hate him, some people in Madison Square Garden hate him, but there's no doubt he has been one of the greatest players in NHL history. Here we have a closer look. And don't forget to get a specially designed personal
jacket. I was drafted number one in 73, and I ran into a brick wall named Al Arbor who said, "You're now in the NHL, young man. You're going to have to learn to play both ways." It was tough at times, and it was great at other times. But in retrospect, just like when I left home and didn't think that my dad was such a great guy when I was 17, I later realized that he was the greatest influence in my life. And I think Al Arbor fits that bill as well. Forget the first time I stepped on the ice as a 14-year-old junior hockey player with the Ottawa 67s. Whether I had a good game or not didn't really matter, but the fact that I was 14 right away made me put me in the same category as Orr, who had been, I think, the only other player who played junior at such a young age. So the next day, the picture and the headline, Denis Potvin touted as the next Bobby Orr. And it was a big thrill then, and it remained a big thrill throughout my career, and an honor, because I've always respected the man for his great hockey ability and for the way I think he changed the game. No, it's always been kind of, oh no. It's Thursday night, I have to go in the garden. But I think about that Wednesday night, and then Thursday I start preparing, or even Wednesday night going to bed, you start preparing for it. And God, you know, you always hear in the old sports arenas how mentally tough you have to be. And Al used to always say, I don't care if the roof falls down, I still want you guys to bat check. A defenseman is really, it can really be the key to the success of the team, and defense is usually the nucleus of the team, and is the part that is going to protect as well as create offensive plays. And I think that there should be recognized that the Norris Trophy winner should be a most valuable player, the defenseman who contributes the most to his team. The Norris Trophy winner should be a most valuable player, the defenseman who contributes the most to his team. The fact is that when we came to play hockey, it was extremely important that, you know, I take care of you and you take care of me, and I know that if my back's turned, I've got somebody protecting me. And in the common sense of the game, you knew that you weren't alone doing a job. We were attacking as a pack, and we all felt stronger because of that. We just couldn't give it that one more shot. I mean, we saw the top of the mountain, and we just couldn't get to it. It was really sad, you know, because of our injuries and a lot of the off-ice. I mean, Dave Larson's father died during the playoffs, so did my father. And you can't believe the emotional strain that brings on an individual. And as close as I explained we were earlier, also meant that when somebody suffered a tragedy in the dressing room, he wasn't alone. But I hope that I've left a lot of good memories, and I hope that when I run across my old teammates and through the years, we can sit down and share some really good stories together. I think that would be important to me.
More intermission activity from the Nassau County Coliseum when Capitals hockey continues on DC20.
Attention! Clean them up and move them out!
It's Bob Rosenthal's spring cleaning sale with over 400 new 1987 cars and trucks, all at pre-price increases that could save you thousands.
I want them peppered, polished, and priced to sell!
Plus, over 1,000 1988s with low-rate financing, cashback, and dealer incentives that'll save you hundreds.
Whatever it takes!
Until this weekend only, and only at one of the world's largest, Rosenthal Chevrolet Jeep Sterling and Rosenthal Mazda, both in Arlington, Virginia.
When it comes to autofocus cameras, some give you part of the action, but Canon EOS gives you all of the action. When it's so dark that some can't focus, EOS doesn't miss a trick. And Canon EOS has computers and motors in every lens for fast focus. So great shots are easy and so creative, the competition is out of the picture. EOS, more than autofocus, easier than ever. Buy EOS today with no money down, low monthly payments at participating Canon dealers.
Quality of the Giant, to me, is the people that we have, the pipe stores that we operate. I think quality is the appearance of the store. We operate clean stores. We try to be the cleanest guy in town, the friendliest guy in town, and the best stock guy in town. I think we are quality right from the entranceways to the very person that escorts you out the door and loads your groceries in your car. And we give you the best quality for your money.
Next time on Star Trek The Next Generation.
So what's the cause of my headache?
I haven't the slightest idea.
An old enemy is playing tricks with the captain's mind. In a deadly game of revenge.
You murdered my only son.
Now he's forced to relive a terrifying battle.
Look for a silver sphere. Destroy it!
On Star Trek The Next Generation.
Saturday at 6 on DC20.
The Capitals continue to outshoot the Islanders. It's now a 30-14 advantage for Washington, but they're down on the scoreboard 5-2 to New York. We'll continue and rejoin Mike Forns after these messages on DC 20.
Swing into spring with style and savings during Dash's early spring sale. Save 40 to 60% off everything in stock. Polywool designer suits, $189. Polycotton designer dress shirts are 3 for $35. Polywool designer dress pants with knee lining, a mere $45. Polycotton designer golf shirts are now 3 for $33. It's Dash's early spring sale, where you'll save 40 to 60% off everything in stock.
Roy's. Where do they get these people?
Now at Roy's, get a two-piece chicken dinner medium fries or a bacon cheeseburger medium fries. Your choice, just $1.99.
I'll take Underwater Farming for $50.
I'll take Roy's for $1.99.
Greg Norman, the white shark.
Hi, guys.
Greg, where do you get all that power when you drive, huh?
Amoco Ultimate.
Amoco Ultimate?
93 octane. Better than power for my car.
Come on, what do you know about gasoline?
Nothing. My car knows.
93 octane Amoco Ultimate for pure power and performance. Your car knows.
Okay, Greg, we're hooked.
Never say hook to the white shark.
They're sewing him back together, so he can tell us how he did that.
I got you up here to kill you.
Ground Star Conspiracy, Saturday at 8 on DC 20.
The score at the end of 40 minutes of play here at the Nassau Coliseum is 5-2. The New York Islanders have the lead over the Washington Capitals. Mike Forns and Al Koken welcoming you back once again to our live hockey coverage here on DC 20. A second period that saw the Caps get on the board with a couple of goals, but the Islanders came roaring back with three of their own. Caps looked like they had so much momentum going their way, cutting it back down to a two-goal game, but that power play has been a great string for the Islanders tonight, and they really made the penalty against Bengt Gustafsson count, go back on top by three. It's an awful long road for the Capitals to come back in that third period. They just lacked that raw firepower. It's certainly not over, but that may have been the key goal. Let's take a look now at the other scores from out of town. We've got some more surprises to pass along to you here. First of all, Quebec and Philadelphia are now tied up. It's now 4-4, and they're in the third period. New Jersey has pulled ahead of Pittsburgh 5-2. That is a third period score at the Igloo in Pittsburgh. Montreal leads Boston 2-1 at the Boston Garden in the third period, and Hartford now trails Buffalo 3-2, also in period number three. Right here, the Islanders with a three-goal lead, and we'll be back with tonight's third period after these words.
You can hear the understandable pride when modern brewers talk about the time they spend brewing their beers, or the time they spend lagering them. True, this reflects effort and care. But for Budweiser, some things take even more time. Like waiting for a big beechwood tree to grow from a small beechwood tree. For all the years past and the years to come, this is the kind of time and the kind of care that go into your beer. Beechwood aged Budweiser.
The 1988 Toyota Celica. Its powerful 16-valve, 135-horsepower engine propels you to the limit, while you glory in Celica's sleek, aerodynamic shape. The 1988 Toyota Celica. The power and the glory. Toyota quality. Who could ask for anything more?
In business, changes are just a fact of life. For example, you can type something perfectly, and then new information comes in.
Okay, that's perfect, but would you change the opening?
Maybe that's why secretaries prefer Xerox typewriters.
Oh, and add that comma.
They make revisions easy. In tests, 8 out of 10 people preferred a Xerox typewriter to other leading models, even an IBM.
And that's it, okay?
No problem.
Xerox, the perfect typewriter for the way business really is.
Some wine experts on Lancer's Blush.
A superb color.
Splendid clarity.
It's good.
Just good?
Okay, superb. Ah!
You are watching DC20, your superstation for movies. Tonight's Capitals hockey game is brought to you in part by the Masonry Institute. Watch out, Washington, brick and block are back. By K Jewelers, the Diamond People. By Safeway. By Toyota. There's quality, and then there's Toyota quality. Who could ask for anything more? And by Buick. The great American roads lead to your Washington area Buick dealers.
The third period of this game, the Islanders lead the Capitals 5-2. Mike Ridley ready at center ice to work against Bryan Trottier. Trottier picks the draw and brings it back to Gerald Diduck. Over to Potvin. Plays it off the boards for Gilbert out at center ice. Here's Larry Murphy ahead to Miller, and as he gets across the line, Ridley's already in. Offside is called. Al, you know, it's interesting looking at these out-of-town scores to consider some of the possibilities. New Jersey, surprising, certainly surprising me, I'll say that, with their performance here late behind the goaltending of Sean Burke. They can finish as high as third place. They could end up with as many as 82 points. They got three games left. They're at Pittsburgh tonight and, of course, host the Islanders on Saturday afternoon, then at Chicago Sunday. They're going to wind up winning the season series over the Penguins if they keep going here, 6-1. And New Jersey, if they win tonight, would be unbeaten in six straight games. Gartner keeps it inside the Devils or the Islanders zone, and a shot by Miller caroms off the side of the net. Now Miller turns it around and gets a shot off. Potvin blocks it. Another drive, and Potvin with a big block there. Gartner hooked to the ice by Potvin. Had the stick up high, and Ridley finally has it touched by Gerald Diduck, and there's going to be a penalty here against the Islanders, Denis Potvin. See high stick Mike Gartner and got that stick up under that face shield. That'll give Washington the power play advantage here to start the third period.
Potvin had made a couple good blocks before that high sticking call. Watch the veteran get out there and use his body once. Got out there and did it again. Now here's the high sticking play. That was the second block he had made. But Kelly Miller had had a terrific opportunity. Here's the close look at it. Miller, though, set up perfectly right to the side there, just a little bit to the left of Kelly Hrudey. The net was open and put it off just the side there to the outside of that post. That, again, seems to be the chronic problem for the Capitals. You get scoring opportunities, nobody's burying the puck to put it away.
Here's Galley on the power play to Stevens, and his shot's deflected and goes up into the seats. Now Pittsburgh, although losing tonight, let's say they come back. They could finish as high as third place and could have more points than New Jersey if they come back and win this game. They could end up with 83 points. There are three games left besides the Devils tonight. They're at Washington Saturday, and they host the Whalers on Sunday. And they don't want to tie the Devils in the standings, I'll tell you that. Here's Hunter getting a shot in there with his stick, trying to pry it free from the glove of Hrudey. And Norton had something to say to Hunter in the aftermath. Gary Galley back on that point with Scott Stevens.
See, the problem with Pittsburgh and New Jersey, if New Jersey wins tonight, they have 36 wins. Pittsburgh only 34. That, of course, the first tiebreaker. And
New Jersey would have an edge then in that season series, points in the season series. So everything really hinges a lot on that game tonight between the two clubs.
Here's Morrow clearing it all the way down. Of course, the Rangers completing that lower section of the division could also finish only as high as third with a maximum of 83 points. Here's Scott Stevens, tries to flip it in front, misses Hunter. Gustafsson goes to the corner after it. Back to the point. Bengt Gustafsson to Scott Stevens. At the side of the net, here's Hunter. Taken away by Trottier, and he flips it out to center ice. It gets away from Gustafsson. Gustafsson goes in, Kromm is with him, and Peters lops it into the corner. And Bengt Gustafsson puts it behind the net for Scott Stevens. Here's Stevens, leads it out off the skate of Gartner. Picked up by Stevens. He's cross-checked by Diduck and gives it right back to Diduck. Stevens and Diduck tied up, and Diduck takes a swing at Stevens with his stick and misses. No penalties called on any of that. Here comes Gartner, working to center ice. Gets across the line. Mike Gartner into the right wing corner. Throws it behind the net. Ridley comes up with a puck from Hatcher. Here's Mike Ridley, back to the point. Over to Grant Ledyard. Now to Larry Murphy. Murphy back to Ledger. A slap shot. It's up high and goes wide off the glass. Now Murphy at the right point. His drive is caught by Hrudey.
That glove hand of Kelly Hrudey is unbelievable. Larry Murphy stinging a shot. It comes in high. It's really going towards that stick side. But Rudy showing all the confidence he has with that catching glove and makes the play. And again, he's able to see it a little better because Gerald Diduck does a good job of getting Mike Gartner out of the way. In that regard, Rudy has had a much easier night than he had a few games ago at the Capitol Center, where Washington players were in front of him all night long, and Rudy really lost his cool on a couple of occasions. But tonight, the Islander defense has done a much better job of keeping the Capitals away from that crease.
The draw grabbed by Norton. It's chased over to the sideboards for Kromm, and he flips it out to center. 8 seconds left on Potvin's high sticking penalty. Capitals one more rush on the power play. Murphy to Gartner, a slap shot, and a glove save by Hrudey. Dynamite goaltending. He stopped Gartner's low blazer. That finishes off the penalty to Potvin. The Islanders are at full strength.
Once again, the glove coming into play. Mike Gartner with the hardest shot on the Capitals team. This one is a little lower than the last one Kelly Hrudey handled, but gets out there with the pads and backs things up with the glove. 33 shots on goal for the Capitals. Only two goals in almost every game this year, as we talked about, Mike. The Capitals out shooting the New York Islanders. In fact, you come into this contest, the Capitals with 207 shots against the Islanders, only 174 for New York. The difference has been Hrudey for the most part, and Billy Smith as well, and it just goes back to that playoff series last year, and particularly Game 7, where Kelly Hrudey made all those critical saves.
Here's Makela in on Rod Langway in the Washington zone. Throws to the side of the net. Trottier knocked to the ice by Galley. There'll be a penalty call here against the Capitals. Holding against Gary Galley. Time of the call, 3:14 in the third period. There's a break in the action. The Islanders lead the Capitals 5-2.
Last week, we bought this great new VCR at Circuit City. They guarantee if we find a lower price within 30 days, they'll refund the difference plus 10%. I'm going to find a lower price.
Right, Harold.
I found it. Oh, it's a Circuit City sale.
Don't they pay anyway?
They pay anyway, even on their own sale. That's some guarantee.
Harold, You're brilliant.
Circuit City, the intelligent choice.
By wrapping up Dennis, or rather Bryan Trottier, Gary Galley gets the call for holding at 3:14. Play is dumped down by Makela. Could have been interference as well before Trottier even had a chance to get it. You see, Gary Galley's already had the stick around the midsection and has lost it as Trottier goes down. So instead of trying to build on a little of the momentum gained during the power play, the Caps now have to kill off yet another New York Islander penalty, and they already trail by three. Just can't afford, if they're going to make a comeback, to be defensive and be killing off penalties in that regard.
LaFontaine jams up now with Gould along the sideboards. It's dumped all the way down by Hatcher. Diduck makes the play. Out to Bryan Trottier. Trottier to Potvin. Sends it across the line. Back in the Washington zone. Peters leaves it behind the net. Here's Langway to move it up the boards. At the point, it's kept in. Trottier right over to LaFontaine. He tried to bank it in off Peters, but missed hitting the Washington goaltender. His angle was so severe. Now here comes Makela on the comeback for New York. Mikko Makela passes to Bryan Trottier. Back to the point for Potvin. At the blue line. Here's Norton. Over to Makela. A slap shot. Deflected by Langway, and now he clears to the point, but not out. Kept in by Norton. Over to Potvin. LaFontaine back to Denis Potvin. Over to Norton. 50 seconds left on the Washington penalty to Galley. Trottier right through the goal mouth. Over to Potvin at the point. Potvin's drive blocked. Makela misfires in the corner. Gives it off to Trottier. Here's Trottier in the corner. Now back to Norton. Norton skates in, delivers. That's deflected just wide. And Kelly Miller picks it up and clears it all the way down to ease the pressure. Down to 20 seconds left in Gary Galley's holding penalty. 15 minutes remaining in the third period. The Islanders lead the Capitals 5-2. Here comes Kerr walking in, scores! Picks the top corner, going over Peter's shoulder on the stick side. New York makes it 6-2 with a power play goal.
Nothing away from Alan Kerr. This is a terrific shot, but how do you let a guy like this get so wide open on the power play? It's just a sensational shot as it gets up there underneath that arm. But still, again, off that wing, too much room to maneuver. Challenged up high is Trottier, and Ledyard can't get back in that regard to recover against Kerr. Seemed to be forced him to a decent angle. I imagine Pete Peters probably should have had that, but it looked like it was a pretty well-directed shot in that regard, but too much room given to guys like Alan Kerr. He's certainly improved his goal scoring this year, now 22 on the year.
Time of the goal, 5:03 in the third period. Trottier gets an assist. And so does Jeff Norton. At 5:03, Kerr scores on the power play. How, where that puck ended up in the net, I thought it had gone over Peter's shoulder. Yeah. Now, I think it may have even hit Peter's stick and gone up under his arm. I don't think he would have just let that go by his pad. I think it might have even hit Pete Peter's goal stick and deflect in up into the corner of the net.
Well, I thought when I first saw it, well, I was giving Kerr so much credit for a great shot, but in that regard, if it does sneak under the arm in that, Peter should have had that covered a little better.
Here's Konroyd off the sideboards, and Ledyard has it at center. Dumps it back into the Islander zone. Jonsson back to get it. Penalty box is empty. Kromm out to center ice. Now Sundstrom leads it to Gartner on the right wing. Gartner fires wide, and Makela tips it out to center ice. The Islanders lead 6-2 with 14 minutes to play. Shot by Hatcher, deflected by Hrudey into the corner. Here's Kevin Hatcher. Sends it back into the New York zone. Morrow up the boards. Greg Smith keeps it in. Now Trottier tries to start out. Here's Ivan Korvo on his backhand. Turns it around. At the blue line, he tosses to the corner. It goes behind the net for Gartner. And Mike Gartner chases it back to the point. Flips it into the other corner. Here's Rich Kromm for New York. Gets it ahead for Konroyd, and he taps it all the way down the ice. Greg Smith back to get it. Icing is the call against New York with 13-13 remaining in the third period. There's a break in the action with a score of the Islanders 6 and the Capitals 2.
Does car shopping confuse you? If you've shopped, and I have, you'll find the one place where the confusion ends is your Buick dealer. That's why I just bought a brand new Buick Regal. Regal is actually priced under T-Bird and Cougar. The new Regal just looks like it costs thousands more. So don't get confused. Shop where you like, but start at your Buick dealer. The car is Regal, but the price sure isn't.
It
The Islanders continue to pour it on. A 6-2 lead over the Capitals. 13-13 left to play in this third period.
Well, they're now in overtime at the Spectrum in Philadelphia. 4-4 between the Nordiques and the Flyers. Poulin has two goals for Philadelphia. Murray Craven with two goals for the Flyers. Lambert, Jeff Brown, Anton Stastny, and Michel Goulet scoring for Quebec. Miller brings it back to Langway. Out to Larry Murphy. Now to Kelly Miller. Miller into the corner. Jammed up by Diddick. The puck still loose. Potvin's bumped out of there by Ridley. And now LaFontaine clears the zone. Here's Langway from center ice. Deeks his way back to the line. It goes into the corner, and Diddick is there to play it off the glass. Langway, right wing side. Kelly Miller takes a shot. It's popped in behind the goal. Here comes Ken Morrow. Out to Derek King. Gets it to center ice. Bassen has to take it back to his own line. Potvin into the corner. Bassen starts out. Gustafsson throws it on the right wing for Christian. Cutting in, a slap shot and a goal! Dave Christian catching the stick side of Hrudey, low to the ice. And Washington is back on the board now at 6-3.
One of the few times the Capitals have had a little skating room in this regard, and you keep it away from Kelly Rudy's glove. David Christian, who scored a goal almost in similar fashion the other night against Detroit, coming down that right wing and then putting it on the far side inside that far post. Get it away from Rudy's glove. You got a little better chance and some skating room for a change. Probably too little too late in that regard, but David Christian, he's just scored now for his second game in a row, and the Capitals need production from him heading into the playoffs.
Gustafsson gets the assist at 8:06 on Christian's 37th goal of the year, and we still have 11:35 to play. Here's Kromm hustling in. He's hooked by Ledyard, but the play is offside anyway.
Tickets for the playoff games A and B on sale now. The dates of the games, of course, depend on what happens in this Patrick Division race. If the Caps end up in first or second, games A and B, Wednesday and Thursday night on the 6th and 7th of April with the 7:30 faceoff. If the Caps finish third or fourth, games A and B will be Saturday and Sunday night, the 9th and 10th, also 7:30 faceoff time. Tickets are available at all Hex ticket centers, or you can call phone charge at 202-432-0200 or the new 800 number, 1-800-448-9009. And tonight, operators on duty until 11.
Here goes Norton to the corner. Tied up by Gould, chased by Morrow to the sideboards. Clear to the point, kept in by Pavanka. Michael Pavanka tries to put it on Hatcher's stick, but it never gets there. Morrow blocks it. Now Galley over to Pavanka. Wide through the goal mouth. There's going to be a delayed penalty call coming up against New York. 2 minutes for cross-checking. Looks like Ken Morrow is going to get the gate. There's a break in the action with the score. The Islanders 6 and the Capitals 3.
Michelob.
Be sure to be with WDCA-TV 20 Tuesday night, the 5th of April, as the Bullets travel to Chicago for an important Eastern Conference game against Michael Jordan and the Bulls. It's live at 8:30 p.m. Join Mel Proctor and Phil Chenier as they call all the action right here on your superstation for sports, DC 20.
Morrow for cross-checking at 8:57 of the third period, giving the Capitals another power play chance and a shot from the point by Stevens. This one went to the glove side of Hrudey, and he made the save.
This is the year I've been impressed with Kelly Hrudey more tonight. We knew he has such a great glove, but he's playing with such confidence, and you see it here, coming out to challenge in that regard. But again, you see the shot all the way. If you're a goaltender, how could you ask for more? Everybody taking off the play. He's got that clean angle to it to come out to make the save.
Here comes Gartner walking into the side of the net. Just misses Hunter. It's into the corner. Larry Murphy along the sideboards. Works it to the point. Stevens hustles to keep it in. Now here's Gartner cutting in a deke. A shot. And it's blocked from right in front by Potvin. Cleared all the way down the ice. Peters makes the play. Out to Gartner. Gartner cutting in. Tries to wrap it around. And the goal mouth. And Hrudey has stopped it. Konroyd and Murphy pushing and shoving. And it looked like Hrudey had that one right on the line.
Mike, I don't think he ever knew it was right there until it was sitting on the line. Gartner, with a terrific burst of speed, comes in and makes the wraparound play. Now, here's earlier, Gartner with a little deke, and look at Potvin coming in to clear the puck. Then you come back, the Capitals, and again, great speed from Mike Gartner, getting the step on Norton, and he just wraps it around. I don't think Hrudey knew it was there as quickly as it was, and it was sitting right on the line. Now, watch it. It's right there, and he doesn't know it until he looks down at his feet, and Gartner's all the way on the other side.
Well, we have a final score now between Buffalo and Hartford. The Sabres have beaten the Whalers 3-2. Dave Andrechuk getting the winning goal for Buffalo. Arneil and Napier had also scored, and Turgeon Tippett both scored for the Whalers. Into the corner, the puck cleared all the way down now by Norton. A minute five still left in Morrow's penalty for cross-checking. Islanders 6, Capitals 3, 10:05 to play, third period. The Capitals' power play unfolds as Christian carries it inside the Islander zone. Poke check by Norton, and he clears it all the way down the ice. Lead pass over to Scott Stevens, to Larry Murphy. Murphy to the blue line, over to Gustafsson, fakes the shot, sends it right in front. Murphy couldn't get anything on the puck, but winds up taking Kelly Hrudey into the Islander net.
Mike, we have some more finals to pass on. The Flyers in Quebec, they end up in a 4-4 tie. That means Philadelphia now with 82 points, two behind the Capitals and the New Jersey Devils. An 8-2 victory over Pittsburgh, 78 points for New Jersey. They trail the Rangers by one in that final playoff battle and jump ahead of the Pittsburgh Penguins by a point, pushing Pittsburgh down to 6 in the Pacific Division.
One bit of misinformation on that Flyer game. We've now been told Willie Huber had the fourth Philadelphia goal, not Murray Craven. So Poulin gets two, Craven gets one, and Huber had the goal that apparently tied it up. Montreal and Boston. Dahlin and Lemieux scoring for the Canadiens, and Joyce, Bob Joyce, scoring for the Boston Bruins, as Montreal leads Boston 2-1 in the third. The draw goes to the corner. Here's Diddick. Sends it up the boards to the point. It skids past Scott Stevens and goes all the way down. Pete Peters stops it there, gives it over to Scott Stevens. Here's Stevens turning in his own end, or to the blue line. Now right side goes to Gartner. He fakes the shot as it knocked down. Back over to Ridley. At the point, here's Hunter. Back to Mike Ridley, to Hunter. He winds, fires, the shot blocked by Jonsson, and he clears it out of the zone. 9 minutes to play. Both clubs at full strength. Here's Gartner across the line. Cranks one wide of the net. Miller hustles into the corner. Bobby Gould goes to the corner. Back to the point. It gets away from Stevens, but he recovers and throws it to Mike Gartner on the right wing. He lofts it into the corner for Miller. Norton comes up with a puck. Now Miller takes it back. Grant Ledyard a shot. That's blocked. It's loose at the side of the goal. Poked over to Kelly Miller. Miller walking in, sends it wide, just missing right through the goal mouth. Here's Bobby Gould back at the point. As it poked away, the Islanders get a two-on-one break. Racing in is Derek King. Only Ledyard is back. He scores! fires it right by Ledyard and right by Peters, and the Islanders make it 7-3.
I don't know if he's going to get an official assist, but give a lot of credit to Alan Kerr. He's the man who's got Scott Stevens all tied up, and that allows the break. Ledyard, the only man back. He looks, is looking to have some sort of pass. I wonder if Pete Peters expecting to pass as well, because he didn't seem particularly set. Led you to that position to try and cut off any kind of pass so he doesn't come over to challenge King. King has the opportunity to shoot, takes it, and cleanly beats Pete Peters. There's been 17 New York Islander shots on goal. They have scored 7 times. Just a woeful defensive effort from the goaltending on out tonight by the Washington Capitals.
Time of the goal, 11:44. Derek King's 12th goal of the season. Alan Kerr gets the lone assist. New York leads 7-3. Here comes Lauer. Back into the corner, Hatcher. Out to Korovo. Works it to center ice, kicks it to the Islander line. Norton plays it ahead now for Randy Wood. Into the Washington zone. Wood chases it rink wide. Here's Korovo off the boards and back inside the Islander zone. Ken Morrow goes to take it. He feeds Norton. Norton cuts into the Washington zone. Wrist shot blocked. Blocked and cleared all the way back to the Islander line. And now there's going to be a whistle here as the play is called offside. There's a break in the action with a score. The Islanders 7 and the Capitals 3.
The stars are going to twinkle and shine. How they'll shine this evening, about a quarter to nine. My loving eye.
They say time is what you make it. At Citizen, we prefer making it beautiful.
Around you, around a quarter to nine.
Citizen, at K Jewelers, the Diamond People.
Capitals still have 7 minutes, 15 seconds to go in this game, down 7-3 as the Islanders continue to dominate in every phase of the game.
Here's Murphy back at center ice. Over to Ledyard. Back to Murphy. Murphy tied up at the center line, and here's Kromm from Konroyd. Charges to the blue line. Now Sundstrom works it free. He feeds Ridley at center, and he dumps it back inside the Islander zone. Back goes Jonsson. Plays it off the sideboards. Bobby Gould ties up. The puck comes to center for Trottier. He works inside the Washington end. Passes into the corner. It goes behind the net. Trottier chases, but lets Kromm pick it up. Back to Trottier. He's taken out by Gould. Now Ledyard chases the puck and feeds it up the middle to Murphy. Murphy out to Sundstrom. Takes it back to the Islander line. Ridley tied up along with Makela on the sideboards, and it goes back to Scott Stevens. Stevens to center ice. Dumps it back inside the Islander zone. King back to pick it up with 6:05 to play. Christian rushing into the corner. Tries to work it free. Out at center, here's Gustafsson over to Scott Stevens. Now passes to Gary Galley. Galley looks for Christian on the right wing, but it's going to be called offside here as Galley touches the puck. There's a break in the action with a score of the Islanders 7 and the Capitals 3.
I can only cook one thing, but I do it very well. My giddy-up chili. I use only fresh, natural ingredients. This tomato came from the garden out back. This came from a chunk of 100% natural Kraft cheese. See, unlike some shredded products, Kraft shredded cheese is all natural. No artificial ingredients or preservatives. Mmm, good. When I'm cooking, it's got to be 100% natural Kraft brand shredded cheese.
We're underway back inside the Capitol zone. The Islanders lead 7-3. Here's an icing call as Gary Galley goes back to get the puck. The faceoff goes into the Islander end.
you examine this game, you look at what Brian Murray has got to be concerned about, the fact that, you know, in every single situation, every unit has been outplayed by Terry Simpson's club. The goaltending has not looked sharp. Certainly the defensemen have not moved the puck with any real great speed and alacrity. The forwards have not come back to help. The Capital Stars have been outplayed by the Islander Stars, but I think the real key is the role players for the New York Islanders certainly have outdone their counterparts for the Washington Capitals. Look at the performances by guys like Alan Kerr, Derek King coming in with number 12 tonight, Gilbert with 17. These are the guys who are completely outplaying the Capital counterparts in that respect. They're completely out-hustling Washington, and that's what's keying this Islander streak lately, the way those guys have come through to combine with the Stars. You know LaFontaine's going to be there every night, Brent Sutter, Potvin, but when you're getting performances like that from Alan Kerr, you're in great shape.
And here's a drive by Pavunka right on net, and Hrudey is able to make the pad save. Now into the corner goes Morrow. Gustafsson back to check him, and Morrow retreats behind the Islander net. 5 minutes to go, third period. Capitals down by four. LaFontaine works to center, gets into the Washington zone, drops it off for King. He sends it to the net. LaFontaine is tripped up right in front, and now Kerr is felled in the corner by Galley. Out comes Pavanka throwing it to center ice, and Morrow dumps it right back in. Gustafsson starts out. Both teams have changed on the fly, and here comes Gartner to the red line. Winds up, his slap shot blocked by Konroyd, and Trottier has it behind the net. Korovo tries to work it out of the corner for Gartner, but now Trottier takes it behind the Islander net. Here's Konroy. Can't clear it out. Hunter knocks it down, feeds it over to the corner for Korovo. Ivan Korovo tries to center. Konroy blocks that. 4 minutes to go. Puck cleared out to center, and here comes Lauer in on Greg Smith. And Smith takes him out, leaving the puck for Kevin Hatcher. Hatcher out to the center line, and it's knocked down there by Diddick. He drives it back into the Capital zone. Hunter to the corner. Can't clear the zone. It's knocked down by Adams and picked up. Greg Smith starts ahead for Sundstrom. Sundstrom punished against the sideboards by Potvanschek. At the point, Hatcher keeps it in. Here comes Hatcher to the corner. Diddick chasing him. And it's cleared out by Diddick all the way back inside the Washington zone. There'll be no icing. Grant Ledyard goes back to get it. Here's Ledyard to center ice, right wing side for Gould. Picked up by Adams. Now Bassen chopped by Bobby Gould. The puck goes to the corner. Ledyard back to take it. Throws it behind the net for Larry Murphy. Here comes Murphy, who has played an improved game tonight. He's been one of the Capitals' bright spots, if they've had any in this contest. Morrow goes to the corner and plays it ahead for Kerr. Back to Sundstrom. Right side now for Larry Murphy. Murphy's pass up to Ridley inside the Islander zone. That play broken up, and Wood starts out, flipping it out to center ice. Murphy goes left wing side. Miller a shot. He cranked that just wide. Now Murphy a drive and a save by Hrudey. Caps had two men parked right in front, but Hrudey kicks the rebound well out. Now King goes to the corner. Tries to center it. Played away by Pavunka, but not hard enough. Miller has to do more work, and now Murphy sends it all the way down as the whistle blows to stop play. And we have a minor penalty call coming here against Randy Wood. Well, against Larry Murphy of the Capitals. And there's going to be a power play, a break in the action. The Islanders lead 7-3.
I've grown up with Giant, and my family's grown up with Giant. And I think they have an attitude, such a deep attitude of caring, that it impacts everything I do, not just when I'm at work, but also when I'm at home.
That's what Giant is. You get people who care. You get people who really want to make sure that your shopping experience is as pleasurable as possible. Giant is what I believe in. Giant has the kind of values that are important to me.
Exactly 2 minutes remaining in the game, and the Islanders can finish it off with a man advantage Larry Murphy for slashing at the 18-minute mark. The Islander power play has been spectacular all night long with four power play goals.
At the point, here's Norton on the power play. Murphy in the box for slashing at the 18-minute mark. Lauer lets one go, but it's just wide. Now LaFontaine back again to Norton. Gustafsson is able to clear it all the way down. Here's a lead pass to the Washington blue line. And Peters stops it, puts behind the net for Rod Langway. Langway sends it up the boards. Goes all the way down past Bobby Gould. Crowd starting the chant for Denis Potvin. And he jumps out on the ice for one last shift here at the Nassau Coliseum during the regular season. They'll have post-game ceremonies to honor Potvin. And the Islanders are trying to set him up. Miller works it out to Sundstrom. LaFontaine backs it up for Denis Potvin. Potvin will handle the puck as much as possible. Here's a pass to him from Trottier. That's knocked down and taken to center ice for Makela. One of the game's great players here, and Denis Potvin seeing his final regular season shift before his home fans. Potvin tips it out to center ice. Jonsson back to play it. Off the boards for LaFontaine and taken down by Hatcher, who knocks LaFontaine to the ice. Sundstrom out at center, backs it up. They want Potvin to play the puck. He gets it over to Tomas Jonsson. Jonsson walks in, feeds Potvin at the point. He fires just wide, and Stevens clears it out. Time running out. They'll let Potvin handle the puck. He brings it back to Hrudey. Out to center. The Islanders win the game. Seven to three, the final score. Shots on goal in the third period. Washington with a total of 38 on the night. Held to only 14 shots during the third period, which is only four shy of the Islander total for the night. But they wind up winning this game with seven goals on 18 shots. New York had four shots on goal during the third period. Washington outshoots the Islanders 38 to 18 and loses the game 7-3. We'll be back with post-game coverage from the Nassau Coliseum after these words.
All around the league, fans, scorekeepers, and once in a while referees know me as number eight. But in banking, numbers just get in the way of good service. At Providence Savings, we all wear the same number, number one. Free checking with interest, offices and drive-ins open till 7 every weeknight, you bet. And more services that meet your needs. At Providence Savings, we all wear the same number, number one.
Providence Savings, member FSLIC.
Personal pan pizza in 5 minutes or your next one's free.
Lunch?
Making it hot, making it fast. Get it in 5 minutes fast. Making it four, giving you more. Chopping and topping, cheese and please. And moving it quick from oven to place. Pizza Hut, making it great.
Come to Pizza Hut for lunch and get a personal pan pizza in 5 minutes or your next one's free.
Pizza Hut, making it great.
There's a whole new look in men's pants, and George and Company has it.
Who remembers their actual first girlfriend?
Her name was Louise. Went to a makeout party.
Levi's Dockers, comfortable pants for all occasions. At George and Company, big and tall and shops.
I would have done better, but I was bald then, too.
Levi's 100% cotton Dockers. If you're not wearing Dockers, you're just wearing pants.
My first kiss, I remember.
Was there a girl involved?
There was a girl involved.
In everyone's life, there's a summer of 42.
Big and tall Levi's Dockers. At all George and Company locations.
I'm Bob Peck, and for almost 50 years, I've been giving you the best Chevy deals in town. So before you pay more, check with Peck. Save even more with up to $1,000 cash back.
Please direct your attention to the scoreboard.
Final score tonight here at the Nassau Coliseum. 7-3. the Islanders winning over the Washington Capitals. The postgame ceremonies for Denis Potvin are just getting underway here in front of a sold-out house, 16,297 on hand, and honoring one of the game's great players in Denis Potvin. And they're listing some of his accomplishments right now on the scoreboard here as this capacity crowd remains standing to honor Denis Potvin. Well, he set an awful lot of records. They gave him the puck a lot tonight. He made some of the plays that he's been known to make with those big blocks of shots out there. He didn't figure in the goal scoring, although the Islanders tried to set him up right near the very end. But as time wound down, we saw in some ways how he's fading just a little bit with age. I think he's going at it the right way. He's bowing out a true hero here in New York.
But look what he can still do, Mike, and look how he can key a team from the blue line. You've got a young guy in Norton who needs some leadership. They've teamed him with Morrow. The way Potvin and Jonsson work so well together, and Denis Potvin just sitting back and basking in the glow of all this and led by example again tonight. How many shots did he go down and block at his age? How many times was he the guy to lead things out of the zone? How many times was he the guy to cross-check and clear people away from the front of the net? Well, you can still do it at that age. You know you've got tremendous value left, and this is the type of guy that makes this Islander team so tough to catch, so tough to come on if you meet him in the regular season or the playoffs. They've got that tradition, and it starts with a guy like Denis Potvin.
Well, every roar that you're hearing in the background is another one of Denis Potvin's many accomplishments that they're listing on the scoreboard, so that gives you an idea of just how much he has meant to the fans here, not only through their Stanley Cup winning years, but those years that led up to that and the few years since then. How about the Capitals? They lose this game tonight. Now that sets up the Islanders for a pretty good walk into first place. Islanders need a victory or a tie to actually clinch it. Philadelphia winds up tying. Capitals gain no points. The Flyers drawing a little closer to the Washington Capitals in the race for second place.
Well, see, the wild part of it, of course, remains that the Capitals can still win first place. They've played very, very poorly, but if they win their final two games and the Islanders lose their final two games, and remember, the Islanders go into New Jersey, a team that is really fired up, and have to close the season in the Boston Garden. Never an easy place to win. Two victories for the Capitals would give them 40 compared to 39, and that would be the first tiebreaker, so the Capitals would win it. But you got to wonder, how can the Capitals muster a two-game winning streak coming out and playing hockey like they played tonight? They were never in this game mentally and certainly didn't finish it off physically. They had a chance to come back, made some mistakes, got penalties, and from the goaltending on out, Mlarchuk didn't start sharp. I can't blame Peters for the three goals he gave up in that second period, but he didn't look sharp coming down in the third period. So where do you go with your number one goaltender? Your defense didn't look strong, even though they dressed seven of them, and the forwards were ragged as well. They were out-hit and out-hustled by the Islanders. Time to turn it around. They've got the time to do it, but they certainly have got to put out a better effort in these final two games, and you worry then about what goes on in the playoffs if they continue to play this kind of hockey.
Here's what has updated the confusion in the Patrick Division standings. Let's take a look at the out-of-town scores right now in the other games. First of all, a final score in overtime. Quebec and Philadelphia wind up at 4-4. New Jersey winning back-to-back games against the Penguins, winning at the Meadowlands, and now tonight at the Civic Arena in Pittsburgh. They win this one 7-2. Montreal beating Boston 3-1 that final. And also in the Adams division, Hartford losing at Buffalo by a score of 3-2. So the Capitals, with just two more games to go, will set the stage for those contests after we pause for these words.
You know, Art, I used to think cable TV was great for sports.
Yeah, me too, Dale. And the dishes we got from Davis Antenna really give us more sports than ever before.
Everything cable got us, and a whole lot more.
Davis Antenna gives us all the sports.
Golf on Thursdays and Fridays.
And baseball, hockey, boxing, rodeo, soccer, and softball.
And my favorite, fishing.
So, sports fans, do what we did. Call your sports connection, Davis Antenna, today.
And get more sports than you've ever imagined. Call today, 1-800-4-ANTENNA.
If your car needs a tune-up, there are lots of choices open to you. But how many use trained certified technicians? How many do over a million tune-ups a year for a low price? And who fully guarantees every tune-up for 12 months or 12,000 miles? Only one is America's number one tune-up specialist, Precision Tune.
Major League Baseball returns to Washington. Don't miss the exciting as the Baltimore Orioles knock heads with the New York Mets Sunday, April 3 at RFK Stadium.
Denis Potvin is waving goodbye to the crowd here at the Nassau Coliseum for the last time during the regular season. He has his young daughter in his arms, and the Islanders tonight have beaten the Washington Capitals 7-3. We'll have some closing comments after this. It's my pleasure at this time.
Major League Baseball returns to Washington. Don't miss the exciting as the Baltimore Orioles knock heads with the New York Mets Sunday, April 3 at RFK Stadium.
So, we asked some of today's leading wine experts to give their opinion on a whole new taste in wine. Lancer's Blush Wine.
Superb color.
Oh, splendid clarity.
Excellent nose.
Lancer's Blush Wine.
Oh, excuse me.
What?
This wine is fruity, light, crisp,
light.
Pretty.
Ah, pretty.
Pretty.
At last I have found my wine. It's good.
Just good? Lancer's Blush?
Okay, superb.
Ah, superb. Yes, yes.
Some things are worth doing. Call 833-7500. Petco, where the switch is on to new ideas.
All around the league, fans, scorekeepers, and once in a while referees know me as number 8. But in banking, numbers just get in the way of good service. At Providence Savings, we all wear the same number, number 1. Free checking with interest, offices and drive-ins open till 7 every weeknight, you bet. And more services that meet your needs. At Providence Savings, we all wear the same number, number 1.
Providence Savings, member FSLIC.
Denis Potvin's wife, Valerie, is out on the ice now with their young daughter as they are honoring the former Islander captain and still certainly an Islander great here in his last regular season home game before these fans. Final score tonight, 7-3. The Islanders beat the Washington Capitals. Clint Malarchuk started the game, played all but 1 second of the first period, gave up 2 goals against and made only 3 saves of the 5 shots that were put on him during the first period. Pete Peters played the other 40 minutes. He winds up taking the loss in this game. He made 26 stops and gave up 5 goals against. Kelly Hrudey, what can we say about the way he played tonight? 60 minutes of work and 35 stops, 3 goals against, and he really had the magic going for him.
He does, but, you know, that presents the problem the Capitals are going to see in the playoffs unless they face Pittsburgh, and we don't know the real talent of a guy like Steve Gannett. You got a hot young kid in Sean Burke, Ron Hextall, a Kelly Hrudey or Billy Smith, or a John Van Beesbrick or Bob Prose. You know, they're all going to see hot goaltenders, and the Capitals better start doing a better job of finishing things off around the net. It's one thing to get beat by a hot goaltender. It's another thing to help these goaltenders out, and in a lot of cases, that's what the Capitals are doing right now.
All right, tonight it was the Islanders' night, but there are 2 games left for the Capitals to make their mark in the Patrick Division standings to get ready for the Stanley Cup playoffs. That's the story tonight from the Nassau Coliseum. Until next time, this is Mike Forens for Al Kokin saying thanks for watching. And so long from the Nassau Coliseum. Tonight's final score, Islanders 7, Capitals 3. Be sure to be with DC 20 Sunday night when the Capitals travel to the Spectrum to take on the Philadelphia Flyers live at 7 o'clock right here on your superstation for sports, DC 20. Washington Capitals hockey is produced by Bill Brown.